Honest Music in a Bottle, episode 80. We're in the building, man.
80.
Yes, man. Shout out to Motu Viget there. Yeah, let's turn this down. Hold up.
Oh, yeah.
Travis going crazy there.
Yeah, he's turning. Yeah.
I was like,
hold up,
bro.
It's jazz and shit playing behind us. We bumping it.
Yes, man, it's Music in a Bottle podcast, episode 80. Yes, we are here. Yes, yeah, for sure, at the Taste of Black Spirits. And Motu Viget is leveraging the Taste of Black Spirits this weekend. And this is a Detroit event, from my understanding, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
A Detroit event that's moved over to Grand Rapids. And shout out to Jelks and the team for putting this on, man.
Yeah, man.
Shout out. We out here.
Yeah, man. What's been your impression of the event so far? We just kicking off. It's about, I think this started at 5. It's 5:45 right now. So. Yeah. We kind of like, we're going to 10 tonight, too.
Yeah, man.
Boy, we going into the wheels, fall. No.
Nah, nigga, this is the hotel. They're kicking us out.
Yes.
9:45, wrap it up.
We going to get y'all niggas up out of here.
Yeah.
Real quick.
Yeah.
And we in West Michigan?
Oh, yeah. What?
Yeah, most of them.
What? We'll insinuate a riot if we stay here.
Y'all can take that Hennessy and go home. we have to taste the black spirits right now, which is super dope.
I love the event so far, man. Like, it's a lot of live energy. They got the hard liquors out here for samples. They got the cocktails out here. They got the ballroom set up in the middle.
Yep.
I'm loving it, man.
Yeah, this is
dope, bro. Shouts out.
It is amazing, man, for sure. To bring something like this to Grand Rapids I'm counting at least 15 different black spirit owners in this building.
Yeah.
So
good entrepreneurs. Yeah.
Which is super dope to see. Man, we met some really cool folks we're hoping to touch base with at Stock the Bar. Shout out to Daryl and Deborah.
Daryl
and Deborah. Super dope. They got the SDP Vodka. Premium quality. Shout out to them. Anybody else y'all touch base with here? Shout out to Nicole, of course.
We connected with her. Seemed like we got a lot of ambassadors for brands as well.
Yeah.
Obviously, Motu is big in here. The whole family of drinks they have are all here. It's just a dope setup, man. I like it a lot.
Yeah.
I think it's really cool.
Yeah.
It's cool music, cool vibe. It's been some cool people.
Yes.
So we definitely gonna sit down with a couple.
Oh yeah.
Crack some jokes, have some fun.
Yeah, we definitely gonna try to get a couple people over here for sure.
Yeah.
Shouts out also to Blush Bottle Service LLC. They got the traveling bartenders. So if you guys are looking for weddings, events, birthdays, and more, shouts out to Blush Bottle Services. They'll get you right.
Okay.
Most definitely. Yeah, we sitting in front of Duke and Dame as well. Shout out to them, man. Who else we got in the building?
Man.
We got St. Liberty Whiskey.
Shout out to Muse. Muse curated all the art in here.
Go ahead, throw a big clap there.
Some mad art pieces in here.
Yes.
Word to my guy.
I ain't gonna lie, I was trying to find parking and I saw the Muse van. I didn't know Muse had a van. Now that mug is matte black.
Come on, man, pull up matte black. Hop out spraying.
Yes.
Like, that's amazing, man.
Yes.
That's amazing.
And it looks nice with the logo on and everything, too.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. They were smart. They rolled, like, right up in front.
Right up in front.
I'm just waiting for somebody to get drunk and knock over our camera.
Look, man, it's going to happen one of these times. You see how she leaning?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, man. Too close.
We should probably move that mug to, like, a window angle.
Leather jacket.
But,
leather jacket.
with that. Otherwise, man, what else went up? What y'all been on?
Oh, man, look, man, it's been a good week. Busy week, working, doing a lot of working, man. Work is paying off, though. Everything is good, as always, y'all. Y'all know what's up.
Blessed and highly favored. Yes, sir.
Can't complain at all, man. I was able to take my guys on the journey yesterday. Was able to hit AC with my guy.
Oh, yeah, we went on a little trip.
A little rendezvous last night.
That was the type of trip that, like, travel. I mean, that trip stayed with me for the next day, and I was a little disappointed, man. Going out with Wayne, man. He don't know.
Hold on.
Wayne was hanging out.
No, man.
What I'm saying. Why you know?
I got you. I got you. But Wayne is the kind of person that is so good in conversation. I'm sitting there. Wayne is talking, but he is not drinking. I have finished six drinks. Wayne told me today, I only had like two or three drinks. I was like, there's no way. He wasn't moving at my pace.
Talking about you a fan.
Look, man. You just got to keep it cool, man. Keep it chill.
Also,
I ain't gonna lie, I was high as hell. So
that's why.
You know what I'm saying? It's easy.
Because I was hungry, bro. And like, there was nobody else on the same time. And then it seemed like, you were on the same time as me. But was it?
They took forever.
In between the stop?
Yeah. Okay. Yep. So it was like, we hit the whoopty. I had to circle back around, hit the joint a couple times, came through. You know, that set me up. I'm cool. I'm mellowed out, ready to talk. I wasn't even mad the food was late.
Yeah, you were really relaxed. Look, hey, Juan, for his food to be so late, look. Bro, his food was literally, it took.
Wow, they took it off the bill, Nick. It was that late.
They took it off the bill.
She came up to me like, yo, I'm sorry. Like, I'm sorry for having your food come this late.
And
like,
you was blow. You had good
why?
Time.
Why? Good I was time. Happy. I just, life was fine. It's Friday. I'm with
life
my guys.
Life was fine.
What can I be mad at, man? Yeah. Look, the thing is, though, you know Daryl, my dog, because he was ready to kill Shorty. He turned into Darren. You know, that's you put the D, that's Karen Darren. Darren, that's Darren. That's when he started getting out of pot. That's what he, excuse
pissed.
Me.
I was pissed, man. I mean, the whole thing is, we had like it's fish and chips is all that my guy would
bro,
order.
It's simple,
okay?
It's simple,
so
man.
Fish and chips.
Simple fish and
exactly.
chips.
Exactly. Actually, they can be cooked in the same.
Like Friday, just Friday's fish stuff.
So, but I watched it, and then someone else at our table, their fish and chips came out, and then I'm like, dang, like everybody eating. But the thing is that pissed me off the most was that Wayne was waiting, and all the while. Two dudes at our table had a three-course meal.
Literally, though, like it's coming through. Like,
bam, bam. Yeah. George had his dessert. By the time he was there.
Are you serious?
Yeah,
bro. It was cool, bro.
That's
it was
crazy.
Cool. I rock with the restaurant, so I ain't gonna blast them. It was all good. It was a busy night.
Yeah.
No issue.
I was about to say, who was it?
Nah, don't even sweat.
No. Restaurant was fire. Yeah, good people. Sure. Restaurant was fire. I mean, it was a busy night. And also, shout out to George Walker. We got to check him out at Noir yesterday, which was super dope. We were on our wine show yesterday for sure.
Man should be stopping here today, so hopefully we can get him sat down for a couple minutes, chopping with our guy. But
most definitely.
He'll be in the building today, stopping in on his world tour.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure. He has a lot going on. George, I'm super excited to chat with him. So hopefully we get him on as well. What else, man? I mean, he ran an event yesterday. We popped in at GR Noir.
Shout out to GR Noir.
Man, shout out to GR Noir for sure. But they held
basically
it was a wine tasting with the weighted wines.
Yep.
And George was ahead of that, as you know. He was the first to be over there. So
they had the Chenin Blanc, Rosés, and Sauv.
It was a sub or a cab? It was red.
It was red.
It was
red.
Yeah.
It was red.
I believe it was a cab.
It could have been a cab.
You might be a sob.
You're right.
I need something to drink.
Yeah, facts.
But yeah, man, for sure. What else we did yesterday? I switched it up last night. I ended up going with some old fashions.
Yeah.
I mixed a lot.
Oh yeah, you was on tip.
I was Mixie Boy last night.
But y'all know me, man. If I'm drinking liquor, we going tequila. Yeah, that's the only thing I'm drinking. Tequila pineapples. Palomas. I finally got a new name for the drink, so I guess there's there's a drink called a Paloma, which is it means dove in Spanish.
Yep. Oh,
but it's like grapefruit, pineapple juice, and vodka or tequila. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's right up your alley, bro.
Yeah, so it's right up there. But it's a very they drink it a lot south of the border. So it was cool to sip on those.
Shout out to Alec.
Yeah, big shout out to Alec. Facts, because she did put me on. She was the one who got me with the words.
I said Alec.
Alec.
Shout out to Alec.
All of them.
Yeah,
the gang.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Big gang. Big
everybody
gang.
Whose heritage is south of the border.
Everybody.
Yeah. all of
Mexico.
Yeah.
Shout out to all the Paris, too.
Yes, please. Yeah, come through. It's okay.
We got finger foods there. So
yeah, look. I got the waiver down. Definitely. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. What? Oh, my goodness.
Oh, yeah. You want to pass it to
Juan? Yeah. I got it. You see how we?
Yeah.
Talk. Is it every? You don't want one?
I think that's bread on there, ain't it?
I don't know what this is.
Yeah, for sure.
I just know I'm gonna eat some. Yeah, thank you.
But I'll take a double bag, please.
Go ahead, get the. I got you.
I trust you. Yeah, we're here.
I was trying to be clean with my hand. Why you want a double egg? You don't like double eggs.
I don't like double eggs.
I know you don't, bro. Yeah. You've been weird like that for a long time. Here you go, bro.
I'm
gonna grab one too. Do I need to use the napkin? I've been keeping using the napkin. I get it. COVID and stuff. I understand. It's all good. Thank y'all so much. I appreciate it.
Boy, Wayne, talking.
Right? I'm all good. Thank you. I appreciate it. Y'all know the vibes, man. We getting catered
I'm super
too.
Excited. Yeah.
Catered too. And
Wayne
I ain't talking.
A social butterfly.
Look.
Uh-huh.
Catered too. And I ain't talking Destiny's Child. You feel me?
Oh my God.
Catered too. What we doing, man? What we doing, man? Come on, man.
Yeah.
That's what we doing around here. It's the guys. They messed up inviting us. I ain't gonna lie. They really did.
It's time to show up and show up.
We gonna
out.
Be niggas here, just like this.
Double egg was good though.
I don't even know what this is. What is this?
I don't know, bro. Like a little.
I'm scared to taste it.
Like a little taco salad in there.
Yeah, for sure. That's what it looks like.
Yeah. How is it? Good.
Y'all hear the crunch on
the
mic?
Yo, what's it called when you can when the videos just
fucking
people eating?
What's them things called, bro? No, what is that? My somethings, bro.
Yeah, it's like whatever. Well, go ahead, go crazy. Start your channel, nigga. Yeah. but yeah, man. Gosh. No, it's like I said, it's super. It's a super dope event. If y'all not here, y'all missing out for sure.
Yeah, for sure, man. We having a good time. I mean, Juan, you've been quiet about your week.
Yeah, let us know.
I was going to get there, but then they came over with these finger foods.
Yeah.
And this mug looky slap.
I know.
I don't know what it is. When you right, it's like straight. a little cracker.
Yeah.
Cracker. Taco.
How was your week, fool?
Pico. Oh, man. Week was all good, Meryl.
Yeah, for sure.
Got back to work. They finally opened up the doors back to my job. COVID took over for a little second.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all back in action.
Can't be nothing without two men. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Pause. We got it, though.
Yo, that was like Randy Moss catch. That was crazy.
I got it.
Crazy.
I caught it in the end zone for you. But
that was like, you ever seen the plays where, like, the quarterback throw it to a wide receiver and somehow it gets bumped up in the air and then another wide receiver take it to the house?
That was one of those.
Yes,
yeah,
100%.
That was one of those.
Well played.
Yeah.
But, yep, COVID, man, if you guys, if anybody out there is still struggling with COVID, prayers out goes out to you and your family. I know it's still hard times right now, but try to live life to the best of your ability. Have fun, wake up every day, love life.
Yep.
But my week has been great. Got back to work. Now, it's the weekend. It's Saturday. I ain't got to work tomorrow.
Yep.
So what's up for the night?
Oh, you ready?
What's up?
I'm ready too. I ain't going to lie.
This was about a podcast, episode right, 80.
After dark.
After dark.
Yo, Pi, how was your week, Brody?
Man, it's been good. You know, we met up on Tuesday. Ain't too much been going through. I got to get some miles in, man. I missed my run today, so I'm training for Boston. We coming for that for
sure. Come on, man.
But, you know, one thing that we haven't been speaking about was a Kyle Rittenhouse trial, man.
You facts.
Yeah,
right.
For sure. We ain't say nothing about it. I know that right now it's going on in terms of the topic. I mean, yeah, it looks like he testified in self-defense at this point in time. So,
right.
Yeah, it is. I mean, he's on trial, of course, but it looks like he's trying to fight for self-defense.
Okay.
Man.
I've definitely been catching a couple court clips.
Yeah.
I know there's been some controversy behind how the judge has been treating it.
Yep.
In his favor, technically. Yeah. Like, he stopped the prosecutor from saying a few different things and asking a couple different questions, which was, obviously, you know how it is, man. You got an old judge, been a part of the system for a while, probably 100%. Defended a lot of people like this for a while. So, I get it, I guess. But, you know, that's unfortunate. Especially, I know y'all seen the clip of Kyle. And him crying in
like
the courtroom.
Collapsing in the courtroom. Yeah.
With the
oh, shoot.
You peeped?
Crazy.
It's crazy. Tears.
He didn't drop no tears. It was just like hallucinating.
Yeah.
He just hallucinated for like 30 seconds. It was crazy.
But, yeah, I mean, and they had somebody that survived. He was shot by Kyle Rittenhouse.
Yeah.
His name is Gage Gross. A gentleman named Cage was shot by Kyle Rittenhouse and survived. And he's suing the city and the county and several law enforcement officers for condoning Rittenhouse's efforts.
Hey, look, man.
Yeah.
When they wild out, go get that money. That's how it is.
Sir.
I ain't mad
you
at you.
To.
I
you
ain't mad
to.
At you. So.
Yeah.
I definitely I agree.
Close.
Yeah, you, bro. You, I'm. Yeah. You know, we gonna keep it. We gonna keep it.
Yeah.
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 Right. Music in the bottle. These fists get in the bottle too, nigga.
Yeah, definitely. Hey, that's on. They don't got no age on these. You know what I mean? These right here. Yeah, you live. Hey, and you live. Fight another day.
Rest in peace to Pops, man.
Yeah, for sure.
What
else,
man?
What else is going on this week?
Man, big things. Shoot. What's been busting? I know we got some new music, but before we get to that, we trying to at least get some
to the culture.
Some culture a little bit.
For sure.
Look, man.
Yeah.
I don't know. I know that was the biggest thing that I was kind of seeing busting around here.
Was it culture?
No, that was that of culture. Was that
the Rittenhouse situation?
Yeah.
Yeah, man, I saw that. In addition to that, I think that just in terms of music, we had a really heavy, heavy week this week.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I will say, before we even get there, I did just peep and I forgot I did see it. Britney is officially, Britney Spears
that.
Is officially.
Shout out to Britney.
She's officially free, man. Yeah.
Shout out to my nigga Britney, man.
My nigga Britney.
Her conservatorship?
Yeah.
Conservatorship has officially ended. It was 13 years, man, which is crazy to think of. But yeah, she is officially free, man. She can live her life how she wants to.
Yes.
I seen her make her post, man. She's excited. She's ready to get back to it, so that's good.
That is what's up.
Yeah, that's been dope. Also, I have been seeing a lot of talks about reparations in certain aspects.
Tell me more.
Yeah, so first they're starting off with the World War II vets. That's one thing that they're reaching out to. So a law is currently in talks of getting formed around right now for World War II vets. They'll pay a bill for them.
Yep.
But the U.S. actually did. It wasn't an official court, like a judicial court, to an extent. Mm-hmm. But they were guilty of crimes against humanity, black people, people of color, and a couple other like just other countries that they've inflicted, or our country has inflicted. It's almost like a civil court, basically, for the world.
Okay.
I forgot the name of the court, but technically they got found guilty. Nothing's gonna come from that except for publicity. But it is a step in the right direction, understanding that while our country, proud of being from here, while that's good and all, there has been a lot of hurt and a negative impact, a negative light we had on the rest of the world. And that has to be recognized, and it has to be done right in some sort. So, yeah, man.
I wonder what that looks like. I mean, the only thing they can pay is, like, there's no 40 acres and a mule. Like, you understand the process. Like, landowners are the most stubborn.
I think that we covered it on the pod, but that black family from Cali who got, like, the beach back.
Yep.
That's the tip of the iceberg of how many times land or anything has been stolen from us and not paid back. Even down to something that's like a TikTok trend right now, they've been talking about how there's a lot of families, like white families in the South, who have their family's historical slave books, like with the names of the slaves and all that stuff, like in their attics, just like, but they won't turn them in. They just want to keep them because they're family heirlooms to them.
That's crazy.
Whereas like, yo, it's people who can trace their families back ancestry with these
100%.
Books.
Yeah, man.
So it's like, at what point is it like, no, you need to get these back?
Yeah,
because
man.
It is a, I don't know, that goes into even just letting us figure out where we come from, you know what I'm saying? So,
and that's what pisses me off the most is because, we could go get 23andMe, we can go get that, but there's no, like, how do you know? Like 23andMe or you do like DNA, you know what I mean, or whatever. How do you know for sure
how far is it? Bro, I did it and it just took me back to, it just said West Africa. And I'm all right, bet.
Same thing. Yeah, Nigerian was what they got.
Yeah. So it's like, but how, where do I don't know where my people are. I don't know where it's from. I don't know who we were.
Yeah.
So it's definitely like, man, that's a step in the right direction, you know? So, hopefully we can see some more growth and some more improvement in that area. But even on a bigger scale, man, the U.S. paying for crimes that they've committed, you know,
agreed.
That's a real spill.
Yeah, for sure, man.
My thing is like, when it comes to that, who is getting in trouble?
I don't think it's like, ever a jail time situation.
Like, does the president?
Nah, you can't toss that up to the press. But
you feel me? Because you can't. But when they say the U.S. committed genocide, like, I live in the U.S. I ain't commit no genocide.
I mean, yeah, but the country in total, it's like that's like saying you were in Nazi Germany at the time, and they say Germany committed this crime. Germany did, as a nation, create the crime. It wasn't the people,
right.
The nation that set forth that thing. So I don't think it will ever be like, hey, we're locking somebody up for this situation. No, I think it'll definitely be, I think the closest they can get to something like that is hurting us monetarily. That's the only way you can really hurt a country is monetarily or go to war. Yeah. Nobody's going to war with us for it. But they'll definitely be like, all right, we'll cease trading for the next 10 years.
Right.
We'll make sure that, we keep you out of global conversations with bigger, situations or things like that.
Yep.
You never know. We might make sure that you guys, all of the military stations that you have in these countries, you have to leave them now. Like, things like that is what can happen to a country, you know? So,
yes. Yeah.
It's definitely an interesting situation. So we'll see how that goes as it continues to develop.
Agree, man.
Yep.
Agree. Otherwise,
I think the closest thing we can get to I got something that can bridge culture and music, talking about how Kanye apologized to Soulja Boy.
Kanye apologized to Soulja Boy. He also, he wanted to squash beef with Drake too, right?
Yeah.
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 So he apologized to Soulja Boy, and Soulja Boy says, that's all I wanted. Shout out to Soulja.
Being big about it.
Yeah.
Definitely cracking a joke on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. That definitely was cool. That was hilarious. Just to see how Ye apologizes.
Yeah.
He said, yo, it's Ye. Sorry, brother. Like, it was like three messages he sent, and it was just like, that was it. But it was like, all right, that seemed like Ye talking. But that was cool. The Jay Prince, though, that seemed like Jay Prince had like a knife to him, like under a coat, like,
you ever seen
apologize,
that?
Nigga. Like, he like, make peace, nigga.
Oh,
like,
my gosh. So Drake, Jay Prince, and they won. I mean, basically, it was with Ye.
Yep.
Jay Prince talked about ending the beef with Drake.
Drake.
Ye,
yep.
Between Ye and Drake. But the call to action is to free Larry Hoover. Larry Hoover Sr.
Yep.
Larry Hoover Jr. is out, but Larry Hoover Sr. is still in incarcerated right now.
Yep.
So, yeah, man. I mean, if anybody could do it, it'd be Ye and Drake.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I mean, if anybody gonna get Ye to say that, it's gonna be Jay Prince.
Standing in the video with him.
Yeah, bro. But like, you gotta. The thing is, Ye, you know, Ye, he's very vocal. He can talk. Bro, in that video,
yeah.
Ye doesn't stop looking at the phone. It's like he's reading a script that Jay Prince gave him. Like, yo, say this. Like, it's nuts. Like, don't go off this list I got for you to say. Like, it was definitely interesting, like, to see it. But
it is crazy, bro.
Hey, man, that's Jay Prince.
That's Jay Prince. I mean, Jay Prince has nothing to say. He doesn't have to say anything,
bro,
man.
Yeah, not
man.
At all.
Crazy.
Not at all.
Yeah. Shout out to him, though.
Definitely. 100%. Look at this.
On December 7th, he was asking Drake to join him on a stage as a special guest to share two of the biggest albums of the year live in Los Angeles, with the ultimate purpose of being to free Larry Hoover.
Yep.
That's crazy, man.
But you know, and obviously Jay Prince, his son, Jay Prince Jr., works very closely with Drake. He's a part of his camp.
I'm sure that'll happen.
So, I'm guaranteed, like, there is a – I mean, Jay Prince stopped the push of this from coming out.
Or the Drake dish
to push it. Yep.
Yep.
You know, word on road. So
yeah,
there's definitely some influence there. And it's interesting to see those how, like, what as a power move. Like, where does he sit on like that untouchable list? Because you talk about like a Diddy being untouchable, but Diddy couldn't do this.
Yep.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what gets you to that
there's
point?
No
where,
way. There's no way.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Like, who all is up there to be able to call a shot like that?
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, this nigga vibing. He can hear that.
It's not good. Hey, they're playing a Tribe Called Quest, so it's like.
You know that's your boy. Yeah, I know.
Q-Tip and them. But, yeah. Like, when I was like in high school and whatnot, and I started really getting into the music, these were, like, some of the guys that, like, I just ran to for real. But, yeah, it's like, I mean, it was like Earth Gang. I mean, not the Outkast type of Earth Gang, but just, like, real chill music.
Uh-huh.
But, yeah,
cool
otherwise.
Vibe.
For sure.
Shout out to the Wayans Bros for the theme song.
That's definitely
electronic.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah.
Shout out to the Wayans Bros, bro. Yeah.
Super hella funny show. Shouts out to Whoopi Goldberg too. It was just her birthday.
Oh yeah.
She turned what?
Y'all thought it was a straight, didn't y'all? shout out to Morgan Freeman.
This thing is stupid.
Whoopi Goldberg, she just turned 66, man.
That's what's up.
Born in New York City, dog. Shouts out to Whoopi.
Shout out to Whoopi.
Gave black females or black actors, actresses, just a different way to game of the 90s and the 80s. So shouts out to you.
Yeah. Most,
that's what's up.
Definitely.
Facts, man. Facts.
Most definitely.
All right, I got man. With that being said, man, we can roll over to it.
Yep.
Hit that music.
Yes, sir. Oh, are we going to go into music? Yeah, we got time. We got time.
We do. We got a couple.
Yeah,
and then we can just go ahead and
keep going. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
First, okay. So I'm gonna say some things that I heard this week.
Go crazy.
First is that let's play that Polo G real quick.
All right.
But yeah, the Polo G remix to Smooth Criminal. Did y'all hear that?
I did. Smooth Criminal.
Yeah.
It's gonna be fire.
Yeah.
You sampling Michael Jackson?
Yeah, he did his thing.
I wonder how that went. Was it like pure clearance?
Yeah.
Or was it like, you know what I'm saying? How did that work out? Like,
it was something nice, bro. I mean, he did his thing.
Hey, this is going up already.
This nigga came in hard in the mud.
Yeah, it was just different.
Hey.
I know, bro.
Okay.
I know.
Hey, I gotta go somewhere.
Yes.
I gotta go do something.
This is I'm driving the car.
I gotta go do something. Yeah, this is definitely nice.
It's just different.
I need this. Definitely need to hear this outside.
Oh, yeah.
Bro, this is a party banger.
Bro,
there's
a point in the song where he asks Annie, are you okay? And I was like, bro, I didn't expect you to do that.
He did.
But you still made me feel like I was supposed to shoot somebody. Polo G, slept on or not in terms of the new generation?
Man, I definitely still think new generation rocks with him. I think that our generation sleeps on him.
Okay.
You know
what
I'm saying?
I think that's true.
What you think, Juan?
Juan time. Juan Tuan
Obey. I'm not going to say Polo G is slept on.
Yeah.
definitely the new generation, they rocking with Polo G for sure.
Yeah. Right.
Even our generation, though, like, oh, shit. Y'all are, like, 2 years, a couple years older than me, so it's, like, a little different.
It's a little different.
Like,
it is.
I'm in, like, a weird gap, I guess. My people fucking with Polo G.
Right. But if you go two steps older,
I was about
like,
to say, go two steps older, a little bit older, they like, and it ain't like y'all not fucking with him, y'all just don't listen to him as much. Yeah. Right?
Because it's like, okay, so I'm not sure, because you're in between Juan and I, right?
Yep.
So it's like Trav.
Yep.
Trav is like
all
right
of us.
There. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, okay, yeah. Trav is all of us, but then like Drake, J. Cole, like while I was in high school and shit, Drake, J. Cole, and they were all coming up. Like,
right. Yeah. That was, yeah. Like,
best Trav I had was like my senior year.
High
ass.
School?
Yes.
Oh, yeah,
that
yeah.
That was like my ninth grade.
That was like my ninth. Yeah, like that was your eighth. That might have been like my ninth or tenth. Yeah.
So, like, that was everything. And, like, they had a whole bunch of Heartbreak Drake mixtapes.
Yeah.
I used to go through those shits like crazy.
Yeah.
So, then you drop to J. Cole, then you drop to Kendrick, and then it's like, it makes it hard, even, like, for Juice.
Yeah.
Like, for me to even, like, because he released something this week as well, but, like, to appreciate that shit as much. Like, obviously, you appreciate Juice, but, like, pull up G, I jumped on the track.
Definitely a different time.
Awesome. Yeah. But I jumped on music. Music, for sure.
Yeah. I feel that,
what
man.
What about you, Wayne?
No, shout out to Polo G. I think that was good. I agree with y'all. I do think it's, like, a gap. But I think what I've been hearing a lot about Polo G is that he is, like, a very hard worker. He really makes some really good music. So, I think I listened to, like, his breakout album. I forgot what it was. But he had a breakout album. I did spin that a lot. Just when it originally came out, but now I'm in a space of like I'm not checking for it, but like if I was, like that was hard.
It's
I
those,
would play that back.
It's those hits. Those hits, man. Like what was that song that he just had it, but it was like on the radio.
Rap Star.
Was that the one where he was like
BMW?
That's
right.
Yeah,
that's everyone knows that song. Even old people know that song.
Yeah,
like is that.
So you just don't even know about it.
When he comes out with those, it's like
you can't miss it.
You can't miss it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's true. We got a lot of music this week, actually, man.
Yeah.
I mean, we haven't been able to digest this. It's Saturday for y'all, so it's very hard to jump on everybody's music. But Rick Ross released something with Jasmine Sullivan at 21 Savage.
I haven't heard the single yet.
That's Outlaws. Look, Stern Rapids, man. Like, this is.
I appreciate you, man.
Seriously. All right. Hella dope.
We're rolling, bro.
We on. 5, 4, 3, 2. Hey, what's going on? It's a Music in a Bottle podcast. Yes, on some legendary shit right now.
Yes, sir.
We got Willie The Kid in the building.
Yeah, man.
Yes, man. Representing as well. Yes, man. This is as being born and raised in Grand Rapids, this is huge for
Absolutely,
sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Big fan. Yeah, we used to play a lot back in the day. You good on some?
Yeah, I'm gonna make sure everybody good. You want to do a sound check for me, Willie? Make sure.
Yo.
Yep, there we go.
All right, we good.
All
right,
I need it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. But yes, thank you so much.
Man,
honestly,
it's an honor to be here.
Yeah, for sure. Highlighting everything, man. I mean, you just had to drop the EP as well. And with this, Motu Viget. Always, man.
Motu Viget.
Viget.
Yeah, yeah. It's Latin.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I wanted to highlight things. What's going on, man? What's up with it?
Yeah, like you were saying, Motu Viget, what a great segue. African-American owned full spirits company.
Yep.
Got 3 SKUs right now, the Motu Viget Brew, as well as Ebony Supreme Vodka. And we just released Eye Candy, a blush wine.
Yep.
An ode to the ladies, you know what I'm saying? Something department for the ladies out there. So we're just getting busy, man. Over 300 stores in the state. Trying to deal with Meyer with 70 Meyer locations right now, which is big.
Yep.
One of the few African American owned craft spirits represented in that pipeline. So yo, it's really good, man. It's exciting.
Yes.
It's exciting, especially coming from where we're from. Coming out of West Michigan, it's like this is a win for everybody.
Yes.
You know, and that's why we thought it was right to do an event like this and bring all of our fellow peers and colleagues who are doing the same thing in other regions, other parts of the nation, and bring them to our hometown and allow them to be celebrated too.
Agreed, man.
I like it.
Yeah, with that distribution, in terms of how y'all reach, right? It's grown so much over these past couple of years.
Yeah.
Now we're talking about 70 stores right now in Meyer.
Yeah.
How far is that? Because Meyer's not just in Michigan, which
regardless. The Meyer deal is just in Michigan for now.
Okay.
Yep.
But we're expanding beyond that.
Yes.
You know, they want to see how we'll work locally first, of course.
Yeah.
It's baby steps. And it's just a huge win again, you know. You're gonna see this every day.
Yeah.
And then you partner that with the fact that we are the only African American owned full liquor license establishment in downtown Grand Rapids and downtown Muskegon as well.
Right.
So that's making history all over
that's
again.
That's huge.
So now we're selling Motu in stores, grocery stores, on-premise, off-premise, restaurants, bars, but also at our own establishments as well.
That's
so we're being represented in different steps, different levels of the game. You know what I'm saying?
Talk about that a little bit too, I was going to say. Talk about a little bit about that importance of representation. Because, you know, that's a big thing. We're in West Michigan. You know how that go.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So talk to us about how important it is for, you know, for the you know, even though we're going into spirits, you know, that, right. that face.
Right.
But for the kids, for right. everybody to kind of see that and be able to look up to that, know they can get that too.
For sure. Just letting everybody know, man, the world is yours for the taking. You know, it sounds cliche, but it's true. I think there's a lot of limitations that we sort of impose upon ourselves when we look at the possibilities.
Agreed.
You know what I'm saying?
Agreed.
So what we doing with Motu, what we doing with these establishments, what we doing just in business period, just in general, it represents the potential, the opportunity that's actually here. You know, I think sometimes we get complacent with the idea that things just, you know, not working in our favor or not coming to us easily, so we sort of conform to what the situations are. But
right.
I think we're, you know, we're breaking the mold with what we're doing right now, and I hope everybody's inspired by what it is we're doing. That's what it's here for.
Yeah, that's what's up, man.
I love it, man.
That's what's up, man.
I love it.
Yeah. I would love to, I mean, I know a lot of folks would love to hear how y'all came together as well.
Yeah, talk sure. about that origin story.
Yeah, exactly.
Sure. For Motu?
Yes, please.
You know, Jonathan Jelks and I have been working together for a long time. Of course, I'm a recording artist. Built the company, Philly's Music Group, back in the day down in Atlanta, Gangsta Grills. Did some things with Warner Brothers, did some things independent.
Yep.
You know, toured the world, did a lot of things in the music. We're still active today. But every time I was doing music, Jonathan Jelks was the silent guy that was helping me handle a lot of that stuff that y'all
right.
probably didn't know about.
Right.
So he was always telling me, man, this music is good. You know, man, you're one of the greatest. We're going to do our thing. And we did our thing. We made a lot of money. You know what I'm saying? Made our mark coming from where we're from. You know what I'm saying? Still,
agreed.
You know what I'm saying? Unprecedented. But he was like, yo, all of this leverage, all of this opportunity that we created, we need to do that back home.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
So we just took the same business models we were doing with the music and brought it back to Grand Rapids.
Damn.
So real estate, spirits company, two bars right here in Grand Rapids.
Yep.
Ambiance GR downtown, opening very soon. And Sip Coffee and Cocktails in Alger Heights as well. Motu Wine Bar in Muskegon, Prohibition Bar on the other side of the Motu Wine Bar in Muskegon. I mean, adventure Motu in Ghana, Africa, you know. So, I mean, it's taking those concepts, everything we learned from the music, and bringing it to just some, you know, some blue collar, roll your sleeves up, get to a business right here in Grand Rapids, Michigan.
That sounds very West
Michigan.
That's
so dope, man.
Yeah.
Talk to me a little bit about vision. You see this 5 years out. I know y'all talk about this, and that's it. That's exactly how this came together.
For sure.
I know how many roadblocks were put in front of you here in West Michigan.
Of course.
And the fact that you guys were able to break through those and do your thing. Talk to me about vision in these next 5 years. What
for like? Sure. I want to expand. I want to do more for other people. I want to be able to be like, and I learned all this from the music business, right?
Yeah, right.
I want to be like Universal
yeah.
and have all of these offshoots doing what they do. You know what I'm saying? I want to make sure my cousins, my younger brothers, like everybody that's been with me forever can do their own thing. We don't all got to rap. We don't all got to sell champagne. We don't all, whatever your ideas
Dude.
Are, I want to get to the position where I can just say, hey, bro, that's you.
You got this.
Go do that.
Yeah.
Whether it's a barbershop, whether it's a tech company, whether it's a whatever it may be.
Yes.
And speaking of tech companies, Jonathan and Jelks and I are also partners in Radiator. It's, once again, one of the only African-American-owned it's actually the only African-American-owned streaming platform in existence.
Oh, wow.
And one of the few platforms for music, period, owned by African-Americans. You know what I'm saying? And that's just for local artists as well.
Yeah.
You know, go to different regions, we see the artists who probably don't get the top billing, like the major artists, we give them their own platform on Radiator. So the playlist plays, the streaming plays, we collect royalties, get them paid through their PROs, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
So again, it's about us coming to the secondary markets, the blue collar markets, the people who are working hard, you know, who may not be in the bigger markets, and giving them an equal opportunity. You know
that's what's
saying?
Up, man. And Radiator, is that based out of Grand Rapids as well?
Oh, absolutely.
I love it, man.
Absolutely. All of this is based out of Grand Rapids.
I think that's,
you know,
the coolest
saying?
Part, man.
Yeah,
you taking something that's so... And even with Detroit on the other side, I'm from Detroit. So being from there, I didn't know nothing about Grand Rapids until I got out here. But being able to provide this platform to where Grand Rapids, it comes out of more than just, oh, it's the Bible Belt, or, oh,
right,
it's,
right,
know,
right.
it's this side. You know, it's more to that. It's deeper than that.
Right.
The community run deeper than that.
Absolutely.
So that's really dope, man.
And then even Detroit, for how much everybody know about Detroit, it's still a challenge coming out the D.
That's facts. 100%.
It's a challenge.
Facts.
Like, just Michigan, period.
Yeah.
Coming out the Midwest, period. You know, like, we got to earn everything we get out of here. You know what I'm saying?
That's
we
right.
can't just walk down the block and then you see the headquarter building for this, the headquarter building for that.
Yeah.
It's starting to come this way a little bit now, but imagine growing up in places like this.
Yeah.
Like, we gotta work extra hard. You know, we gotta be extra smart, think out the box.
Yeah.
And make sure we move in that order, you know?
For sure, man. I can appreciate that. I can appreciate the economic imprint in the city.
Oh, absolutely.
Which is huge, man.
Yeah.
And also for the folks, like, y'all reach out too, so it's not just like y'all getting money, but it's also and building businesses is also inspiring.
Right.
Yeah.
The fact that you said, like, you don't have to do this. I want to invest in tech. I want to invest in this. I want to invest
sure.
in real estate.
For sure.
That here. That's what's up, man.
And it's, and again, like we're like if not the first, the only, to do a lot of these things.
Talk about it.
You know what I'm saying?
Talk about it.
I want to emphasize that, not to brag, not to boast, but I think sometimes we do great things and we kind of just go to the next thing. You know what I'm saying? Or we do great things and people are like, okay, that's good, but nah, man.
Yeah.
Nah, man.
Let them know.
You know what I'm saying?
It's bigger than that.
Like, this ain't been done before.
Yeah, it's new.
It ain't been done before
out of
the space that we're in. You know what I'm saying?
I love it, bro.
And again, it's not about that. It's just about letting everybody know, man, we can do this stuff, man.
Yeah.
We can do this. You know what I'm saying? Absolutely.
I love that. Transition, you okay with music?
Yeah, absolutely.
Catch me if you can, the EP.
Yeah.
Talk to us a little bit about what you got going on.
Yeah,
there,
me and
man.
My bro V Dawn out of Harlem, New York. That's my boy, that's my man. You know, we've been making music together for a long time. We have a whole catalog, him and I actually, of projects, Deutschmarks 1 and 2, Blue Notes, Heather Gray.
Yeah.
We got installments, you know what I'm saying? So I've been so busy growing these businesses, man, that I haven't been
That's
able to get in the studio.
Be. That's how it should be,
and, you
bro.
Know what I mean? And do my thing, but I need the music as a creative outlet. It's therapeutic, you know?
Yeah.
And in the music industry moving so fast right now, I know if you take a day off, you're already a year behind. You know what I'm saying?
That's
it's so
true.
Disposable. Like, people drop something. This is the hottest album. This is a classic. Oh, my God. The next week, they're not talking about it no more.
Yeah.
It's gone.
I thought
it was a classic. I thought you loved it. Next week is old.
Yeah. No,
like, and like my son's 14. He said something to me one time that it let me know this is a new world with the music. It was a record. I forget what record it was. I think it was like Bad and Bougie when that came out.
Yep.
And then like it came on maybe, no lie, man, maybe like 2 or 3 weeks after it just hit. He said, Dad, why you singing that old song? And when he said that, I said, damn. Not only did he make me feel old, but he let me know that it's a new day.
Music,
it's a new day. Like, my boy said, why you singing that old song? Yo, that song was out for like 3 weeks.
Right. It's different, man.
But they
it's
moving different. Fast. It's just the access to information.
Yeah.
You used to have to go get a CD.
Yeah.
I mean, like, I grew up on CDs and tapes, honestly. But, it was difficult to go get them.
Yeah. And just saying that to say, been so busy growing these businesses that I let a lot of days go by without putting no music out.
Right.
And me and V-Don was talking like, yo, we can let the fourth quarter come by and we don't touch the fans and put something out for the supporters.
So
one thing about me that I'm really fortunate, I got diehard fans that's going to show up no matter when or what, whatever I do. And I'm forever grateful for that.
Yeah.
I don't got to stand and get on Instagram and TikTok every day. But whenever I decide to do something, they come and they support. And I'm internally grateful for that. You know what I'm saying?
So I feel like that's definitely from an OG standpoint. Too though,
Word.
Being like in the game for so long,
right?
You know, and not coming in on a gimmick,
right?
Like, that wasn't how you came,
right?
So like, your audience is here because they know what's coming every
man,
time.
Whenever I show up, man, the last show I did before the pandemic was in Chicago. I'm talking about wall to wall sellout. I'm talking about like couldn't even move in there. That's my first show in months. You know, like so whenever I decide to do this, it's like Jelks always say, man, you only rapping because you're nice.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You do business for a living.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a good point.
That's the thing.
I'm only rapping because I'm one of the best, if not the best, for what it is I do.
Yeah.
That's the only reason why I do it. It's therapeutic.
Talk that talk, Willie.
But the business is where I want to drive everybody to.
Yes,
I just do this because I'm nice, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's it.
You know what I mean?
I thought you was the man. Look. I thought he's freestyling for a second.
Yeah,
I was like, let's go.
No, man, going on your own sound, you know what I'm saying? Talk about the artists you enjoy right now. What's some artists that you like? What's the music you drive to? What's the music you listen to now?
Yeah. I listen to everything that come out. Because you be on social media, they hype up every album. Oh, this is a classic. It's the greatest album ever made.
He's the
GOAT. All
right,
let's see.
When
I play it, it'll be nothing. You know what I'm saying? Don't be nothing.
Come on, man.
It's nothing.
Come on.
Like, what is this? All right, next. Who's the next GOAT? Nothing.
I like it,
What's
man.
The next greatest album ever made?
I like
nothing.
It.
You know
like
what I'm saying?
That.
So a lot of it's trash, actually. You know what I'm saying? But the artists I do like, Future, my favorite rapper. You know what I'm saying? Like, always got some
legendary.
Future in rotation. You know what I'm saying? My man Rock Marciano, always in rotation. A lot of the guys, they'll make a song that I like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I'll play it. One thing about me, I play a song till it ain't no more. You know what I'm saying? So I hear something I like, I'll probably play. It'll probably be a record, be my theme song for the whole week. I'm playing that song all week. So you get the other guys, they make a record I might like and I'll play it.
Yeah.
So I'm starting to get more into just listening to music and not artists.
Right, okay.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I just want to hear good songs.
Yeah.
I just
want to
hear vibes.
Quality.
I just want to hear moves. I just want to hear creativity. I just want people to push the envelope. And it's been a very long time. I want to be inspired.
Yep.
I want to hear something that made me be like, nope, I'm going home, go right.
Yep.
Pull over and go home.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I remember being young, and that's why I really started doing music. I'm listening to these guys, and it's blowing my mind.
Yeah.
I wanted to tap into that energy, you know what I'm saying? So Anytime I hear something I like, you know, I'm on that, regardless who the artist is and regardless the genre, you know.
Shout out to Future, for sure. I mean, yeah. we just had a conversation about, you know, just how much of a pinnacle. I mean, he's up here, you know, in terms of pedestal and how a lot of people, like,
yeah.
You can sum a lot of it.
That last 10, 15 years of rap.
Yeah.
You got, like, everything past that, you got to give a lot of that to Future.
Of course.
He inspired a lot of that sound for, like, the new kids.
Of course.
A lot of that is baby Future.
For sure. Yeah. And Drake, too. Like, yeah, I think Drake and Future and my man Rock, and I think Migos. Drake, Future, Rock Marciano, Migos. Like, those guys who I can always rely on to make some stuff that's gonna make me be like, okay.
So how you feel about that CLB then while we're here? That Certified Lover Boy.
I like the songs.
Okay, yep.
I think when you get to Drake level though, it's hard, man.
It's different.
It's hard to please the people. Yeah.
Especially when you're gonna do numbers no matter what.
And what people don't understand too, you know, after all of the rap and all of the Instagram and after all of the commentary and the podcast and all that, he gotta go back home and be a regular person with all this success.
He got a kid,
he got a family.
Man, that's hard to think about.
People don't see and they don't care about that part.
Yeah. From a consumer level.
All this like, CLB better be the greatest thing I ever heard. Yeah. And that's it. Like, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, I like the records on there. I like a lot of records on there. I tap into. But at the end of the day, when you get to that level, man, it's almost unfair.
It's different.
It's almost unfair. It's, you know what I mean?
So how you feel? I know you talked about the music industry and how you translated some of that into your business.
Sure.
How do you do it into the creative standpoint of your business? So, like, you go into pairings, like, do you listen to certain music while you sip on Motu versus when you taste eye candy versus when you drinking the vodka? You know, how you feel in, like, your music palette and your taste palette?
Well, first, before we talk about the palette, just the aesthetic. Yeah. I designed this bottle. Okay. This is my work.
Yeah.
The front, the back, the label, the name, everything. Yeah. This is mine.
That's,
you know what I'm saying? So me and my team collaborated to bring this together, but I sat on the computer and designed this. The Avani bottle as well,
that's
the vodka
crazy.
Bottle with the vegetation.
Yeah.
I did that with the see-through glass with the strip. Yep. I designed all of that.
That's crazy.
The eye candy bottle with all the women's faces on it.
Yeah.
I designed that as well. So we're talking about creativity. This is all my work.
Hands on for real.
Whoa, what do you mean?
Got to be. That's tight,
from the logo into the names, everything. It's a collaborative effort with my team. Shout out to my team, but they always put me in the hot seat. To be the creator. So speaking of creativity, but as far as pairing, I'm gonna go mine, you know what I'm saying? Like, eat, cook, you know, try different spirits, tap into different things. So I'm always pairing something with something else all the time, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's why I like the Motu, it's real diverse. You could use it for like a Bellini or, you know, something in the morning, like a mimosa or something like that. Because it's apricots and pear and apple notes in here that go really well with orange juice or a cranberry juice, you know, something like that. So that's always on my mind every time I bust a move. You know what I mean?
That's what's up. Well, you know us, man. Look, we every time we gotta go get a champagne, you know we grab it.
That's much appreciated.
I think
it's interesting to hear you say that. I appreciate that. You know what I'm saying? I think that anything that comes out the hometown, I do the same thing.
Yeah.
Anything that we make at home, that's where I go.
I
come to Grand Rapids, I want a coffee, I go to Mad Cat.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep. If I want anything that we make here, if it's a beer, I go to a local brewery.
Yep.
You know? If I'm in a restaurant, they got a list of whatever it is, I pick all the local spirits.
Michigan Craft, Drafts,
everything. Everything that we do home, like mom and pop, Michigan, particularly Grand Rapids, that's where I go to.
Got to.
And I think a lot of times, we gotta be careful in our communities. I think the success or the hard work that people put in, it starts to impact the community the one way or the other. I've seen more Bel Air and more Moet and more Don P in the hood than I've ever seen before in my life.
That's facts.
Because we got Motu. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
And that's unfortunate.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it ain't about me, it could be anybody. If it was your company, I would say the same thing to my man.
Yeah.
Like, why you grabbing that Bel Air, bro?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, bro got the Motu out of town. Like that, like that's what
agreed.
I was.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I grew up here. All the brothers here, you know, Henny, Remy, you know what it is.
Yeah.
No one even champagne dudes like that. But you can pull back my pictures when I was a shorty, I always pop champagne.
Right.
That's why I started with the champagne first.
That makes
always
sense.
Pop. We White Star when I was a little kid, before I could even legally drink. I always pop champagne.
Yep.
As soon as I got a turn, it went from that to the rosé. We do our own thing, Motu.
Yep.
I expected to see Motu everywhere when we dropped this. I saw more Bel Air in brothers' hands than I ever seen. You know what I'm saying?
But I think you touched on a good point, especially when you're talking about you going to the hood, like that 49507 district.
Yeah, 06, 07.
I can see that. I definitely see a I think it's those, everybody that's trying to make it out is in support of everybody trying to make it out.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, when I get around my Duke Turvey, shout out to my guy.
Yeah. Shout out to
different
Duke.
People like that,
that's
where,
my boy.
Where it's like, yo, we, bro, it's Mo 2 on the floor, it don't matter.
Man, Duke always support. You know what I'm saying? It's certain brothers in the community, I always see them with the Mo 2.
Yeah.
And salute to everybody that supported. Yeah. Not because it's me, but because it's us.
Yeah, 100%.
You know what I'm saying? It's out the town, so support the town. It's like, I always say all the time, we can't all do the same thing.
Yeah.
If I'm making a champagne, I wish somebody was, I don't know, start a glass company.
You know what I mean?
You know what I mean? Like, if I'm, I don't know what it could be. Like, if I'm selling cars, you should open up a detail shop, open up a mechanic shop.
Yes,
so that we can trade in business. That's how other coaches do. That's how other communities do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man.
And we got to do the same thing. You know what I'm saying?
I agree with that, man. From your standpoint, do you see a lot of correlation between the music business and spirits business or the wine?
Absolutely. Because hip-hop rules the world. Everything is inspired by hip-hop.
Yeah.
If it's in a hip-hop song, a hip-hop video, a hip-hop figure, it's going to bleed immediately into the business. So there's a direct correlation. I mean, you know, back in the day with Jay-Z shut down Kristoff, you know what I'm saying? Like, we've been had the power. Now we just got to wield it a little bit more.
Yeah.
And you see what Diddy did with Ciroc, it's amazing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and we can go on and on and on. Like, it's probably so many music supported spirits in the market right now than ever before. When I say music, I mean hip-hop.
Yeah.
Everybody from Wiz Khalifa to Ross to Diddy to, let's say, Bruno Mars got a joint over there, I see. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
for sure.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
It's crazy. So, it's a direct correlation. And it ain't just the spirits. It's anything we do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, anything we touch turns to gold.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I think so, man. Hip-hop does run the world. But you see, I mean, even The Rock had to release some rap this past month.
Yeah.
And he got the little, what, he got Vodka or something?
Vodka over there,
For
sure.
You see how things run.
Yeah, man.
I want to say, man, thank you so much.
Oh, man.
Time,
it's a pleasure,
man.
Anything based here at home, man, count me in. You know what I'm saying? Count me in.
Yeah. We definitely got to get you when we chilling in the studio somewhere on the
for
vibe,
sure,
man, and kicking
sure.
it.
I'll come by, bring some more too, man. We can kick it. You know what I'm saying?
Agreed.
Absolutely. And thank y'all for coming here and supporting us and supporting all the African American owned craft spirits. Shout out to everybody, man. Nothing but peace and blessings and success to everybody.
Appreciate it, man.
All right. All right. The guy.
Hey, what's going on? It's the Music in a Bottle podcast. We're still on episode 80 here at this beautiful event here in Grand Rapids.
Yes, sir.
Wanted to touch base. We definitely want to get just what people are going through here at this event and see how the experience has been, right?
Yeah.
So, we have a guest. Talk to us a little bit. What is your name and where are you from?
Sure. So, my name is Kuziva.
Okay.
I live in Kalamazoo right now.
Okay.
But originally, I'm from Zimbabwe. I actually moved to Kalamazoo 3 years ago, I lived in Grand Rapids for like 11 years,
really?
And I relocated there just because my family's there, and so it was just, you know, a much better option, but I travel quite often, and a lot of the times I have to go to like Chicago or Detroit just because there's not many like spaces where black people are,
I love that. Talk to, I mean, representation, it sounds like it's important to you, is that correct?
Absolutely.
Yeah, what does it mean to you?
It just means being around, you know, people that look like me, being able to relate to one another and just be, you know, vibe, you know. So.
I feel that. I like that.
Right, so going into that, you know, switching off the serious topic, just a question for you. If you were a spirit, what spirit would you be? So would you be tequila, vodka, rum, whiskey? What's you? What who you with?
Oh, my gosh. So I've had, like, a mixture of a variety of stuff so far. But I'm a whiskey girl. I love whiskey.
That's
so
different. You're different. Yeah. Okay.
All right.
What got you into whiskey, though? What made you hit the whiskey move? What got you into that?
I don't know. I just like the taste. It's a little smoother. It's not as, like, rough on the throat, you know?
Yeah. Okay.
That makes sense.
So if you had to be a specific drink, what drink would you be? Like, what drink resonates with you the best? Like, what's your drink?
So I'm keto all the way. So whatever I drink has to have like something diet or whiskey and Diet Coke.
I love that.
I like that.
What about? Hold on.
What you got?
So you got one album to listen to. You're on a beach by yourself, you're stuck on an island. What album are you going to?
Oh, I'm an African girl, so I'm gonna go to Burna Boy, DeVito.
Okay.
That's what I'm gonna do.
Burna Boy. I like it.
I love it.
All right, my last question I got for you, and you gotta keep it honest with us here on this podcast.
Please
now.
Do. Yeah.
You gotta give us your craziest drinking story. What's the craziest drinking story you got? You gotta give it. You gotta let us know. You gotta keep.
Are you guys ready for this?
I'm A.
This is what we're here for.
Oh, my goodness.
Get a bottle. Yes. What's up? Let us know.
Oh my goodness. So, it was 3 years ago. My brother was moving to Colorado.
Okay.
So that's my sister over there.
Okay.
I'm the oldest. He's the middle. But he was moving to Colorado, and we were celebrating him moving. So we went out for drinks, and you know, initially started with like tequila and Diet Coke. Next thing you know, we had like 3 tequilas and Diet Cokes.
Yep.
And next thing you know, my brother's like, oh, let's do shots. So we have
like
10 shots.
It sounds like we
have 10 shots of tequila, each of us.
Damn.
And we got home. My brother pulls up in his Miata, like sleeps in his car.
That's crazy.
My sister is in a hammock in the backyard.
Yeah. Yo,
that's crazy.
I was sleeping on the porch in the backyard, so.
Oh, it's lit.
Yeah, for sure. Y'all had a little camping trip, huh?
Yeah, right. No, I feel that. Yeah. That's lit. That's lit.
I love it. That's what's up. That's what's up. How do you like the event so far?
No, this is amazing. Like, I wish we had more places and events like this in Grand Rapids.
Yeah.
This is great.
It is. That it is, man. Much appreciated.
Thank you. Thank you.
You
I appreciate
so
you for taking the time.
Thanks for having me.
You.
Yes, you too. Yeah. Thank you.
Bet. Hey, what's going on? It's the Music in a Bottle podcast, episode 80, man. We are blessed and highly favored to be here with Daryl from SDB, Vodka, for sure. Daryl, we got a pleasure to meet. Actually, Wayne, you met Daryl before this, but yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, most definitely. Got a blessed to meet him and his wife, Deborah, who run the Vodka company, man. Wanted to talk to you. What's going on with SDB, Vodka?
Hey, man, first off, I want to tell you that I appreciate y'all for allowing me to be on this platform. And congratulations and salute to you. It's just something that started in our basement, man. I'm from Benton Harbor in Kalamazoo area, and I decided to have people up to stock my bar with 2010.
Yeah.
And everybody came and stocked my bar, and we called it a Stock the Bar Park.
That's what's up.
So we had over 200 people at our house about 2014. My wife said no more of too many people, so we started having it at venues.
Yeah.
And 2019, we had it at a venue where we had 500 people from all over the country.
That's what's up.
And they had a ticket price. We had a live band. We had PJ the DJ.
Shout
we had catered food.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wedding. Yep. Yeah. That's the guy.
Yeah. He's the official Stock the Bar DJ.
Okay.
Yeah,
he's a fool.
Yeah, he's real good, man. Salute to PJ, man. I really appreciate what he's done for us, man.
And
we donate money to the Boys and Girls Club from our parties from Benton Harbor, Kalamazoo, and Grand Rapids, man.
And,
so I started doing the YouTube videos back in 2019, introducing everybody that I know to Michigan-made alcohol.
Okay.
And my cousin said you should do Michigan only, so I did Michigan, and a distillery got in touch with us out of Lansing and said, would you like to come out with your own vodka? And I told him nobody does that. And I woke up at 4:30 in the morning for 10 months. I prayed, I meditated, and I went to Mr. Burger across from my house before I went to work, bro. Yeah, man. And I did that for 10 months, and I learned how to sell. I learned how to brand, and I learned how to sell alcohol. I haven't got my license, my liquor license from the state of Michigan. And we came out December 1st, 2019, man. We
2 years.
Yeah, man. So it'll be 2 years in December, man.
Yeah,
December 1st.
You're coming up on it in a couple weeks.
So that's how it started, man. It started organically, man. And it's been a good journey, man.
That's what's up, man. That's inspiring, too, man, for sure. Definitely. From your standpoint, your wife runs this with you. And what's your vision for SDB?
I would like to have our own distillery one day. But I would like to be successful to help somebody else out, man, because I had nobody to turn to ask about how to sell alcohol. Nobody. So I just had to read books and go by what I know. And so I'm the first one through the door gets the blood on me. So I'm getting all the blood on me. But I can't wait to tell other people how to do it, to make it easy. So that's what I want to do, be successful, to help somebody else out.
I love that.
Talk a little bit about representation. You know, we're at an event now where, you know, this is all black. You know, this is pure black. It's black excellence. It looks beautiful out here. Talk a little bit about the importance of, you know, having events like this and a representation within our community. I mean, we're in West Michigan, so you know how that goes as a start. But to be able to put something like this on in Grand Rapids downtown, talk about that importance.
This is phenomenal. This is dope. Salute to Jelks. Salute to everybody that did this, man, and invited us. We appreciate it. Invited all the other vendors, man. The best part is seeing everybody that looks like me.
Yeah.
That come from the same background as me. comes from the same background as all of us, man. What y'all doing? It's still the same thing, man. Yes, it's just alcohol is something different. And it's phenomenal, man. And it's big.
Yeah.
Because all the kids can look up to y'all and look up to me and look up to everybody else, man, and say, I can do that.
Exactly.
And that's all it's about, man, is seeing black and brown people succeed. And that's what I'm happy about, man. I'm very happy.
That's what's up, Daryl.
I love it. So, you know, talking to business talk, let's get over into music. We got a Music in a Bottle podcast. That's okay. So we definitely got to, we blend the music with the spirits. That's our go-to. So talk a little bit about your music taste, though, G. I know you're going to kick it back a little
bit. Yeah, you know, I'm old school.
No, let us know, though. Let the youngins know what
well,
you want to listen to.
Yeah, yeah. I like the young music, man. It's everything is not for everybody.
That's right.
Yeah. So my generation before me didn't like what I like. That's okay, though.
Yeah.
I still, that's why people like Jay-Z and them, they put out music not to sell records. They put out music for me to listen to.
Right. I love that.
So yeah. I'm still an Ice Cube, Scarface. You know, those are my era that I love.
Yeah.
We don't put Scarface in the top five in Ice Cube. I do.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
So,
but you're not, that's not off, though. Like, them legends.
Yeah, sure.
I mean, they made this.
Yeah, but I love hip-hop in general, man. I don't dislike anything new just because I don't rock with it.
Right, yeah.
It's okay.
Yeah.
People have kids that rock with it. That's what it's about. So I enjoy it, man. I love hip-hop. Everything, the culture is what it is.
I got to have a little fun with you. We're going to do a this or that. I'm going to give you, like, three questions real quick, all right? Actually, let's go with Ice Cube or Scarface. Who you taking and why?
I'm taking Scarface because they were so underrated when I was young.
Ghetto Boys is who he's referencing.
Yes. So Ghetto Boys were so underrated that I had friends that was like, man, they sound like they hitting on pots and things like that. But look what it came to. They made people like them.
Okay. Yeah.
And that's hard to do.
Yeah.
Coming from the West Coast and the East Coast, they were from the South.
I love that.
People didn't really, you know, it didn't travel like it did now. I had to buy the Source magazine and see what's coming out a month from now.
Agreed.
So that was big. So Scarface knocked down a lot of those boundaries with Ghetto Boys and, you know, rap a lot records and, you know what I'm saying?
That's huge.
So
that's huge.
That's what I'm
about to say. Next question, I got one. So you mentioned East and West. Go for it. East Coast versus West Coast. Where you going?
I'm a West Coast guy.
West Coast?
Yeah,
okay.
I'm a Death Row Snoop and them first guy. I stayed up to midnight to buy Snoop first record.
Doggy style?
That's 92.
Yeah.
I graduated in 91, so I stayed up all night like kids do now.
Yeah.
I did that back then.
Okay.
So,
okay. Wow, that's interesting. That's an interesting perspective.
All right. Last one. Underground Kings or 3-6 Mafia?
Underground Kings. Definitely.
Ooh.
Definitely.
Okay.
UGK, bro. Come
yes,
on now.
Sir.
Come on now, man.
I like that. I like
that.
See
Bun B, man. Pocket full of stones, man. You can't go wrong with that, man.
That's
yeah,
it.
So.
That's respect, man. So, anything you want to share with the people about the brand, man? Anything? Yeah.
Let them know where they can reach you at, where they can buy from, all that.
Stock the Bar, Vodka, everything. Instagram, Facebook, everywhere, man. We in over 100 stores in the state. We're in 30 Meyer in the state. We'll be in Uccello's Monday. We've been all six Uccello's in the city.
Okay.
So they're gonna have a special drink on the menu called the Bloody Mary.
All right, y'all. So we back again, man. Music in the Bottle podcast, episode 80. We still running.
Yes.
We had the Motu Black Spirit event. You know, it's a vibe. And we just getting some guests at an event, asking some dope questions, you know, chilling with some cool people. So if you want to introduce yourself real quick, let them know who you are. If you live in the area, things like that. What got you to this event? How you get here?
Okay, cool. Yeah, my name is Kururama. I'm from Kalamazoo, Michigan.
In the mic, just a little bit closer.
There you go.
My name is Kururama. Yeah, I'm from Kalamazoo, Michigan. I kind of found out about this event on Eventbrite.
Okay.
I'm always looking for events to go to where it's like predominantly black, where the vibe is vibing, but it's hard to find in Kalamazoo. So, I looked in Grand Rapids and came across this event. So, happy to be here.
Most definitely. I mean, I think you touched a really good point there, because it is really hard to find events that look like us.
Yeah.
And in West Michigan as a whole, whether you're in Grand Rapids, Kalamazoo, especially when you get to the lakeshore.
Yeah.
So it's super dope. You guys drove up from Kalamazoo, which is
45 minutes.
45-minute drive. That's what's up. So how's the event been so far?
It's been good. It's just nice to be in a space where you see people that look like you, music that reflects like things that you enjoy doing.
Yeah.
And honestly, like we got here, we didn't really know that the tasting was like liquor.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
We thought it was wine tasting.
Hey, look, we thought it was gonna be a little bit more wine, but we
thought so too.
Hey,
yeah.
But, hey.
There was two wine tasting tables, and the rest were like liquor. culture. So, you know, it was like tequila and whiskey and, you know, but it's been a vibe. I really, really enjoyed it.
Okay,
so,
that's what's up.
Yeah.
That's what's up. So, with that being said,
we got a couple questions for you, you know what I'm saying? Just a couple. So, we're going to see what you level out. So, going into it to start, what's your favorite spirit? Like, what's your favorite drink? Is it a certain type of wine, or is it like a rum, a whiskey, a tequila, a vodka? What's your go-to?
I'm a bourbon girl.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
We out here.
That's new.
I love whiskey. All right. I try to stick to the dark, but I really like the smooth dark, like the, you know, the one that makes you go like.
You're not going off of Hennessy. Nah, you don't want
no
Hennessy.
No. I've had Hennessy enough times to know that it's not for me.
I feel that. I understand.
Yeah. We just had that conversation.
Oh, yeah,
bro. Just saying, like, it's just, no.
I can't.
Do it.
I don't even know what was going through my head when I was on that time. Like,
no.
I was on pure demon time. It was not necessary.
It's not.
It's like a big relax. Calm down. So if you had to say there was a certain spirit that represented your personality, what would that be? Like, what's that go-to drink for you that's your spirit? Who is that? What's that?
Oh, my God. So, okay, this is going to sound cliche, but when I came here, I was introduced to a spirit right here on this corner, and it's a salted caramel whiskey.
Okay.
And it's like Starbucks mixed with whiskey.
Okay.
And
okay.
I loved it. And I swear to you, that's like my new.
That hit you.
That's my new drink. Like, I'm there. That's my drink.
Okay.
Yeah.
I like that.
I can appreciate that for sure.
Definitely.
Talk about music. You got a chance to be on you're stranded on an island. What one album are you listening to in music?
What album?
Yeah.
Damn, like, I'm a dancer, so I love Afro music, Afrobeats.
Okay. Yep.
I think right now, obviously, Wizkid is like
everything.
That man,
but not only
y'all just
Afro.
Heard Essence play here.
Going on.
Yeah, but like even before Essence and this album, you know, like Wizkid was on top. Like, but I'm African, so I love Afro music in general. So yeah, anything African, Afrobeats, Amapiano, like. I'm there.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep.
I like it. So my last question for you, my final question. You gotta keep it honest. You gotta tell us the truth.
Okay.
What's your craziest drinking story? What's the craziest one? And you gotta tell, not the second craziest, I need the craziest story.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay. My craziest drinking stories. I feel like my sister told you.
You think that was it?
That was it.
That was it for you?
That was
it. Nah, because y'all live two different lives. I don't know what your life looked like compared to
hers. It don't get that crazy. I mean, it doesn't get much crazier than 10 shots, though.
Like she told you in Chicago.
10 shots.
In Chicago, we went to Fremont.
Okay.
We went to Fremont, Chicago, bottomless mimosas. But we had some people around us that also like to take shots of Hennessy.
Yep.
Okay.
So we took a lot of shots of Hennessy.
Okay.
And I don't remember the name.
So how you wake up?
I woke up feeling fine, but I didn't remember shit.
Where did you wake up?
Yeah, how'd you wake up?
I heard you were floating in the air.
Yeah, what was that wake up though? Like, where did you wake up? You gotta give me that.
So,
where was you at?
I woke up Sunday night at like around 10:00 p.m.
Hold on, when did y'all start?
Sunday morning.
Okay.
Around 11.
So you took a nice nap.
Yeah.
Midday. Yeah. I like it. I love it.
It was embarrassing.
In a hammock, right?
No, that was another night.
See, I told you. We didn't get that. We didn't get that story. That's a different story.
No. This was like in September. This was like a month ago.
Okay. Oh, this is recent.
This is recent.
Okay.
It was my sister-in-law's 30th birthday.
Okay.
And we went to Fremont, Chicago, and they have like bottomless mimosas.
Yep.
So we had the bottomless mimosas, bottomless brunch.
Okay.
But we also had like 10 shots of Hennessy because it was her birthday.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's her.
No, I like how y'all party.
Yeah, for sure.
I like how y'all party.
Okay. No water.
I don't like it. But that's what happened.
I feel it.
I woke up at 10 p.m. So
that ain't bad. That ain't bad. It's a lot better than waking up in a hammock. So yeah.
Facts. Hey, look now.
I know that story.
That's what's up. Well, we appreciate you being a guest. Most definitely.
Thank you
for stopping by. Appreciate you.
Hey, what's going on? It's the Music in a Bottle podcast, episode 80. Blessed and highly favored. Here we are with Lazar Favors, man.
Represent Duke and Dame. He's representing Uncle Nearest as well. Wanted to kick off with Uncle Nearest, man.
Yeah, man.
You're out of Grand Rapids.
No, I'm out of Detroit. Out of Detroit.
That's
out
that
of Detroit.
City, baby.
Yeah, Cash taking the building.
You know, big Detroit thing. Cash Tech, the Ivy, y'all like.
Come on.
That's the only high school I know you repped your whole life. Like, that's
your whole life.
You can say that forever. Like, yo, I'm with the Cash Tech. Yeah, you got it.
CT.
And they do got talent that come out of there.
Big Shine come out of there.
You know it. No, it's some big ones out of there.
Aaliyah too, right?
Aaliyah come out of there. So many. Bria Stinson. Oh my gosh. Hoss. Oh man. Yep. She dope, man.
And I heard Lazar Favors was out of there.
Yeah, out of there, for real, man. I like how you did that.
But yeah, man. So you here at this at our event here, man, at Grand Rapids, man. We just want to touch base with you. How's the event going so far?
Oh man, things are beautiful. Look around, man. It's a lot of beautiful blackness in here, man. It's a lot of creative energy in here. I love it. I'm feeling great. It's my first time out to Grand Rapids.
No way.
Yeah, first time out here. I didn't know it was this lovely out here.
Well, you finally made it to the best side.
Yeah. I'm going to let you ride with that today.
All love, man, for sure. So you're here representing a few brands, but let's talk about Uncle Nearest, man. What's up?
Well, Uncle Nearest is the fastest growing whiskey in American history. It's a woman-owned brand. It's the gentleman who taught Jack Daniels how to distill whiskey.
Oh, wow.
So it has a lot of, for me, it's legacy. Yeah. So the reason I partnered with that brand was for the story.
Okay.
Like it had nothing to do with, I had nothing to do with wanting to sell liquor or nothing like that.
Yep.
That story had to be heard. And it was one of them things where, we do a lot of stuff.
Oh, yeah.
We create a lot of things.
We a lot of firsts.
We a lot of firsts. We get paid last, but we a lot of firsts.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Right. So when this came about, it was one of those things that you couldn't just tuck away, right? You know, our brilliant leader of Uncle Nair's Farm Weaver, she made sure it happened.
That's what's up, man. That's what's up. I love that. In terms of, we got Duke and Dame as well.
Yeah, Duke and Dame in the building. Duke and Dame. I'm looking for somebody to do a song about Duke and Dame. I'm just telling y'all right now.
That's not
a bag in the court.
Wow.
I'm serious. I'm very serious.
Okay.
I'm very serious. So Duke and Dame came by way of Uncle Nearest.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
It's two brothers, Shima and Amani. They out of Florida.
I love it. Yes.
You know, they've been in Michigan probably a year.
Okay.
It's actually the third best flavored whiskey in the world.
Oh, wow.
So it's dope, you know. Represent them. It's dope.
It's dope.
LS Cream Liqueur.
Yep.
Which is a cream liqueur, again, by way of Uncle Nearest.
Okay.
Right. When I say by way, I mean the relationship I built with Uncle Nearest. They was like, you probably should talk to this gentleman that we got on our team for your brand. Right.
Right. Yeah.
So, Island John Vodka, Den of Thieves. And the way I came across the Island John Vodka and Den of Thieves was when I did the first Taste Black Spirits in Detroit.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Right. The first Taste.
You was a part of the original. The first.
I am the original. Not
come
saying
on,
it.
Man.
Not arrogantly. Not, just saying, like, that's. Like, when
come I. Come on. What are you talking about? Come on, man.
When I say that, I mean, we birthed it.
Yeah.
In,
yeah.
in Detroit, May 23rd and 24th. It was a 2-day event at that time.
Okay.
This is actually our fourth installation.
Okay.
When I got with Skrill is a good friend of mine. John and I know these guys are amazing. So when we sat down at an event and we were discussing Grand Rapids Taste Black Spirits, it was like, yeah, let's put a date together.
Got to. Why not?
Because the whole intention of Taste Black Spirits is to bring awareness worldwide, not just city to city. Like, yeah, okay, if I take it, we can take it to Grand Rapids, that's a whole nother audience. That's a whole nother couple thousand plus people aware of what these spirits are.
Right.
Not
yeah.
just what we're doing, what we're introducing them to.
I love it.
I love that, man. Yeah. Let's jump into music.
Yeah, it's music time. So let's talk a little bit about, you know, our whole podcast is about music in a bottle. So it's about pairing that wine or pairing that spirit with your music preference.
Okay.
So talk to us a little bit about your music taste. Where you going? What you like to listen to while you're drinking, man? Give us a song.
Yeah, I know who Jacob Banks is.
Jacob Banks. Why that sounds so familiar?
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Okay.
They introduced Jacob Banks through Power.
Okay.
Oh, no. We know Jacob Banks.
Oh, yeah.
James Vickery.
Okay. James Vickery.
Boy.
That's a bad boy.
boy. He is in my immediate playlist.
Yeah.
You understand? Toby and Wigway.
Okay.
Come on.
G Roy coming in. Yeah,
right. Yeah. So I mean that's and I'm old school, so Jay-Z automatically. Eric B. and Rakim.
Yeah.
I dabble in Scarface. I dabble in Cool J because he was the first one with that. I need love, and he killed it with that. I'm just going to keep it 100. Like,
no, that's that joint. I know, like, the first verse.
The flow is cold.
Now. Yeah.
I'm alone in my room.
Sometimes I stare at the wall. You know what I'm saying? What you? I did all the thing. Come on.
But when I'm drinking whiskey, I'm breaking the lyrics down to Jay-Z, right?
Okay.
Yeah. I'm really, like, I've been following that dude day one. I remember I met a partner of mine, introduced me to him at the tunnel in New York, right?
Okay.
And I promise you, I'm like, nah, I don't believe you until I heard him that September. I'm like, that's that dude?
Yep.
I knew at that point, the way he structured language, the way he structured his words, like, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yes.
That's him.
Definitely the GOAT. Definitely the GOAT out here.
For sure.
That's crazy.
I love it, man.
So yeah, those are my vibes. I mean, you know, Lela James, I'm old school.
But that's the thing, we appreciate that though.
Yeah,
Music in a Bottle,
sure.
We definitely understand the importance of, we didn't get to this point in hip hop or
right.
R&B without you know those five.
Right. Right. I mean, without James Brown, it's impossible.
Yeah, we're going all the way
Come
back.
On, man.
How far
yeah.
back can we go?
Yeah,
so
for sure.
We definitely appreciate it.
Hey, what's going on? It's the Music in a Bottle podcast, episode 80. We are here at the event, having a blast.
Yeah, it's a vibe.
Got
it's a vibe.
Guests going, talk about the event, their experience here.
Yeah.
What's your first name?
Ebony.
Where are you from, Ebony? Okay.
Awesome.
How's that event been so far?
Oh, it's vibing. It's a whole damn vibe.
A whole damn vibe. I like it.
I love it. I love it. So you're here at this event. What does representation mean to you?
What is it what?
What does representation mean to you?
Oh, it's huge, because I'm a therapist.
Okay.
Representation
okay.
is therapist. Very huge.
Like child or adult? Or
I do it all. I'm a trauma therapist.
Trauma therapist? That's what's up. That's
EMDR
what's up.
Trained. Only clinician of color in King County.
Okay.
Let me do my arm real quick.
Okay. I like it. Talk about it.
Obviously, letting loose tonight. That's what's up.
I like
the
it.
The whiskey is the whiskey.
Yeah.
Hey.
Right over there.
Okay. Okay.
I love it. I love it.
All right. Let's
so, yeah, representation is very important. Obviously, in your space, too, right?
Oh,
as a therapist.
Yeah. Big deal.
Not only for you, other therapists, but also for people to speak to, right?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. Huge. And in this space here, you said the whiskey has been great. Tell me a little bit about your favorite spirit here.
I can't tell you no names, but I know it's 93% and it's right there.
Duke
93.
And Dane.
Shout out to Duke and Dane. We just had that interview. Our guy.
Yeah, shout out to Lazar favorites over
I
there.
I did recently hear that the person that owns this actually trained Jack Daniels to get their whiskey. So I said, hold on now, this is top dog.
That's Uncle Ernest.
Yeah. Uncle Ernest is his name, y'all. He put us on, he let us know, he gave us the whole history, so. Shout out to Uncle Ernest, the real Jack Daniels, you feel me?
Yeah, seriously.
You know what I'm saying? And, yeah, it's a vibe. It's a vibe for the whiskey. So talk to us again. He said, so talk to us about your favorite spirit. So you a whiskey drinker? That's your vibe?
I am. I'm typically an Apple Crown to the head. No
to
chaser.
The head. No chaser.
No chaser. But you know, then I kind of went to wine. I'm getting older.
Oh, really?
I'm 30
now. That's what's up.
Okay.
What kind of wines we sipping on?
I like Zinfandel.
All right.
With my filet.
Okay, talk about it. No, I like the pairings.
Yeah, for sure.
Talk about your pairings, girl. Okay.
Listen.
Okay.
Y'all got a bougie guest on here today.
No, I like.
Oh, no, that's what we do. We cover wine, actually. So it's right up our alley. Zinfandel is that's it.
That's it. Yeah.
That means you have a mature palate. So we like it. Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
So,
so with that, if it was a spirit, that would be you. So if there was a drink, that would be you. What would that drink be?
Oh, man, that's good.
Yeah.
Right now?
No, well, it can be, but like
spirit.
If there's one,
like a,
if there's,
yeah,
a, if there's like a, if there's a drink, so like a tequila pineapple or something like that, what's you? Like, what would that be for you? Like, with your personality, what would that drink be?
My personality.
Yeah.
Huh. I don't know. That's a good one.
You know, I be asking them sometimes.
You kind of stalk me on
here. You know, sometimes I do questions and answers.
You do be asking them.
You
yeah,
know?
For sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what's up. All right. Let's talk about music. You talked about your favorite wine, but music. What are you listening to right now? Who are some of your favorite artists?
My favorite artist right now. Well, I'm a J. Cole person.
Okay.
Okay.
I love. That's my homie.
Okay.
J. Cole. And then I kind of listen to trap music.
Okay, no, give us that though. Who you spinning? Who you spinning?
T-Grizz.
Okay.
From the city.
No, from my city. Yeah, yep. I'll take that. I like that.
I love it.
Okay. That's dope. All right, so before we let you go, I got one more question for you. What's your wildest drinking story?
Wildest drinking story.
What's the wildest drinking story you got? Yeah, you looking at us. Yeah. Nah, we need that real answer.
Yeah,
I told you the last question. I needed all truths.
Yeah,
don't even play with me. Not the second. Your wildest.
Okay, so I was living in Chicago.
Uh-huh.
And I was with some colleagues, basically.
Uh-huh.
And
okay.
They're very country.
All right.
And so they was messing with that moonshine.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And
that 99.
Yeah. No, they had that 100.
120, yeah. That's crazy.
And so I just got the knocking them bitches. I'm very competitive, so if you tell me I can't do something, I'll prove you wrong.
Okay.
So they telling me, oh, yeah, you ain't got it. And I'm hitting them. Boop, boop, boop. I woke up in a clothing basket. You know, like.
In the, like laundry.
You was
like
doing
laundry.
Like, yeah. Like head to my knees, like ass down.
Yeah.
Damn. I was close. Hey. Now, I ain't never got crazy. I was close.
No.
I was
hey.
Up.
Hey, look
I
now.
I was folded up.
Oh, I know.
And I don't know how I got there.
Yeah. You was washing clothes. That's what
I
it was.
Yeah.
No, you were still mature. You still had it together.
Yeah. I love it, though.
Good time.
We appreciate you for
stopping
by.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for the invite.
Of course.
Awesome. Much appreciated, Ebony.
Yeah.
Let's get it. Hey, what's going on? This is Music in a Bottle Podcast, episode 80. We're here with the man.
The myth. The legend.
Appreciate it, man. Jelks in the building, man.
First of all, I'm just happy to be here with one of the hottest podcasts out of West Michigan, too.
Yeah.
This is crazy.
Appreciate it. Music in a Bottle.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate you,
brother. It's an honor to have you guys here for this experience.
Thank you, bro. Thank you.
You deserve your flowers for this, man. This event is crazy, amazing. Definitely, it's beautiful to see, my guy.
Thank you.
Yes. Wait, you got it.
Man, first, man, let's just talk a little bit about the event, man. It was good to talk to Willie, man, catch up with him, catch up with his new music that dropped, talk a lot of the business, but go into yours, you know? I mean, you behind the scenes for a long time, but a lot, you know? Yeah. So just go into, you know, how you got to this point with all that.
You know what? Serial entrepreneurship, it just kind of was a natural evolution of what I was doing. You know, I always wanted to be in ownership. I want to be able to create opportunities. I want to be able to create a pipeline to, you know, new industries where, you know, people haven't always been represented. And, you know, I come from Southeast Grand Rapids, and a lot of us have been excluded from opportunities historically. And it's on our generation, right, to build a foundation where there wasn't able to be one previously. And so I apply that philosophy to everything that we're doing, and hence the Taste of Black Spirits is one of those manifestations.
And another thing that's big important, we talking like black spirits. Like everything in here is black.
Yes, sir.
Like this is black superpower
black
stuff right here.
Baby.
This next level.
Yeah.
Talk about the importance of representation in West Michigan.
That's right, man. West Michigan is a beautiful community. I grew up here, but one of its greatest challenges is the lack of diversity. The lack of people that you see in certain entrepreneurial spaces, the fact that financial institutions don't get money out of the doors to African-American entrepreneurs. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got bars for you. You know,
yeah,
you
know, no, keep going. Right? No, yeah.
So, you know what I mean? It's just incumbent upon an individual like myself and like you guys to bridge the gap, to create those opportunities. And you have to be intentional, and you have to put your money up. You know what I mean? I spare no expense to create this experience.
Yeah.
You know, not, you know, to pat myself on the back because I thought it was important. We have over 30 different African American founded spirits companies in the building tonight in downtown GR. And I want each of these different spirits brands and companies to have, you know, the same legs that we have with a Meyer and a Spartan Nash.
Yep.
You know, we want them to be able to expand their distribution opportunities.
Yep.
So we're just staying focused, man. You know, like the ladies say, know the assignment. You know what I mean? We understand what we came to do,
yep,
and we getting that done.
Man, I love it, man. I'm honestly, like I said, man, it's dope to be here and see this, man. This is crazy. Like, to be in a situation like this, to have people coming from, I mean, there's people across the nation in this joint right now.
Sure.
For real,
Chicago's in the building.
Yeah,
Detroit's
in the building.
Milwaukee's in the building.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. We really, you know, it's about building community. You know, we feel like we have a lot to showcase here. But in order for the city to truly evolve, you have to embrace these types of things. And you have to create what you want to see. If you want to stay in Grand Rapids, yeah, you better be a creative. You know what I mean? Shout out to Carver Stories and, you know, all the creatives and the creators out here.
Yeah.
If you're not willing to create what you want to see, you might want to move to Atlanta. You might want to go to, you know, Charlotte, a place where it's more thriving and the ecosystem is already going.
Right.
But for those who are builders, you know what I mean? I try to liken myself to a master builder or an architect.
Yep.
You know what I mean? I want to do it from home, you know?
Man.
It means the most. Home is where the heart is.
Agreed, man. That's such an interesting concept. I never thought about it like that when you talk about, you know, I always talk about how much I love being in GR.
Yeah.
But I talk about it in the sense of being a creative out here is fun because you get to build. Mm-hmm. But I never looked at it like, yo, you are a builder, and if you're not, you probably like lost, or you're not, like, why is it like this?
It's
you
hard.
Know, yeah, it's tough. If you don't want to make what you want to see.
That's right.
That's nice. What's some advice, man? You've been in, like, business for a while, from music to spirits, and just beyond. Talk to those young entrepreneurs who need that push. Yeah. What's some things they can take from those lessons you learned?
First of all, do your research, you know, and try to carve out a niche. Those two things are vital. You know, now that the internet is here and it's so present, there's no reason to be ignorant about any specific area of business that you want to master.
Yeah.
So utilize the internet, that's your best friend. You can literally teach yourself the law if you want to start your own law practice now. You know, when I was coming up, you had to go to the, you know, library and then get into the Encyclopedia Britannica, read three or four different books and copy the papers at the copy machine. Yo, in this era, all you have to do is pick up your phone, go to Google, Wikipedia will give you a start, and then you can dig into more deeper materials from there.
Yeah.
So identify your niche and then do your due diligence, do your research, and then start building out your business model and figure out how you can make it viable, you know. Be practical. Allow your creativity and your imagination to flow. But also think about viability. What is my target market? Where can I start? Who's already a constituent or a patron of mine?
Yep.
And how I can turn that into dollars.
Man.
You know?
Yeah, agreed, man. Get them boys the tools, man.
Yeah.
That's facts. Yeah. That's facts. I love it. What do you see for not just your spirits, but everything in the future? What's next for Motu as a total and a brand? I mean, because this is an event. And I can definitely see more events coming with the opening of, you know, the different establishments y'all got coming and stuff like that. What's next in the next 5 years?
Yeah, so for us opening up the liquor license establishments that we already have under construction, Ambiance, GR, Kitchen and Lounge coming before the end of the year. We've been holding on to that thing throughout the whole pandemic.
Oh, yeah.
We had to pay bills on it throughout the whole pandemic. Didn't get one PPP dollar, you know what I mean?
Man, talk about it. PayPal, talk about it.
You know, pay downtown rent. It's been quite exhausting, but it's been well worth it because, you know, where we're at, man, is in the main artery of the city right there on Pearl in Ottawa. And we're going to be doing things like this with consistency down at Ambiance. So we're really excited about that. Obviously, our projects up on the Lakeshore and Muskegon, you know, we're doing two bars up there. We probably expounded on it, but we have the Motu Lakeshore Wine Bar in the front space. And then we have the Prohibition Bar, which is going to be, you know, kind of like a concert venue, more open bar concept in the back space.
That's crazy.
So, you know, I mean, we're really excited about that. And then Sip Coffee and Cocktails on our Alger and Eastern is our latest project that's going to start construction before the end of the month. And it's a coffee shop bar hybrid. And that's going to be good. But in 2022, you can expect for us to make some major announcements about what we're doing in cannabis. We're not only going to be doing some stuff with some strains and some branding, but we definitely have a dispensary, consumption lounge, that type of project in the works.
Man, y'all turning it up, man. Y'all going nuts for it, man.
Yeah.
I love it. I really love it. Talking more, we talked a lot of business talk, a lot of cloth talk. Let's talk more into this music in a bottle. So we gotta talk your music taste.
Let's talk
man.
Music. Man.
So going into music, man. Let us know right now. What's your music taste like when you crack open some O2? What you listening to?
Mafioso rap. You know what I mean? All day, baby. You know what I mean? I'm probably the biggest Nas fan. You know what I mean?
That's your there you go, there you go.
Biggest Nas fan, you know what I mean?
Come on, tell these guys.
You know, my favorite album is It Was Written.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? Right. That influenced, man, how I dress, you know what I mean, the way I communicate. You know, Nas just, he had that perspective. And then even with what he's doing with venture capital, all his investments in tech, that's been a great influence to what me and Willie and Jamiel and some of my partners are doing now. So I'm a big Nas fan, huge Wu-Tang fan. Jay-Z, big Hov, you know what I mean? That goes without saying.
Yeah.
And then right now, Kendrick Lamar is special.
Oh, yeah.
K-Dot is special. Drake is the best hit maker that I've ever heard.
Yeah.
J. Cole is like the foundation. He's like the soul of music right now. There's so many I can name, man. You know what I mean? Pusha T, you know what I mean? For the you know, for that. You know what I mean? Restoring the feeling, as they call it.
Oh, yeah.
I always love pushing for that, you know?
Talk a lot. I want to hear a little bit more about Willie. Let me know that you was a behind-the-scenes guy, you know, early in the air, like, when he was moving.
Yeah.
Talk a little bit about that, man, and that upbringing, and how y'all even got connected
DJ Drama's all our big homie. And he's much older than us, and them boys brought me down there to Atlanta, man, when I was, you know, barely out of high school. I couldn't even get in the club. And this was during the Big Meat Show. You know what I'm saying? I was young. You know what I mean? 18, 19.
Atlanta going off at that time.
In the Big Meat Chair, BMF, the stuff that they're making the movies and stuff about now.
Yeah.
I saw the tail end of that at its crescendo.
Yeah.
And I also saw African American businesses thriving at million-dollar levels that I'd never seen in Grand Rapids. And it's crazy because I grew up in Southeast Grand Rapids. I grew up in what was the hood at the time.
Right.
But my parents are both highly regarded and esteemed professionals. My mom is a lawyer and my dad is a college professor.
Dad is that guy. Yeah,
he's that guy. He has his doctor. You know.
Yep.
You know, but I grew up in the neighborhood, so even with all their success, I had never seen young black millionaires and DJ Drama and everything I saw around the affiliates, you know what I mean, was that, man. I was on the set with T.I. in L.A., and then the next day I was with Gucci Mane, you know what I'm saying? When, you know what I mean? He was having that run, you know what I mean? That took him to the next level.
Yeah.
I was around all those guys, man. It's probably P. Diddy, you know what I mean? I've met all your favorite rappers, you know, icons, Lil Wayne, you know what I mean? When he first started coming around with the Double Cup, I remember when he made Lollipop.
Yeah.
I remember when he performed at the BET Hip Hop Awards. He did this incredible live performance. And, you know, obviously, you know, being with the affiliates, being with Gangsta Grills and all that whole movement, man, that gave me significant insight on what it could be. And I always have been a big fan of hip-hop, but I took what I learned from hip-hop and applied it to business. I never wanted to really be an industry guy, but I always, you know, loved the art and the culture, you know?
Man, that's incredible, bro. That's incredible. Because a lot of people would stay in that lane.
Yeah.
And for you to be able to take it, you and your associates, Willie, all that, Willie kind of had the same notion where it's like, yo, we learned a lot from this and we want to move it to that next side.
Willie's an incredible artist. And the industry is so crazy because at the time, there wasn't really an artist like him. You know, Lupe and those came, you know what I mean?
Right.
After, and they had more direct label support. Lupe being out of Chicago and having more direct connects with the bosses at Atlantic, he was able to just take off.
Yeah.
But Willie was like a Nas of his time.
Right.
At that time, coming out of Atlanta, it was hard to get support for that type of music.
Yeah.
So we were Atlanta-based with an artist from up north who was reminiscent of, you know, more Nas and Wu-Tang and Biggie.
Yep.
And that was an interesting combination. But what he was able to do out of that was create such a sustainable, independent music career.
Yep.
You see him in Alchemist and you see him in West Side Gun and all the different things that they're cooking up. And, man, we've just been having a ball ever since. That freedom, man, has been liberating for him. And then we took all the business rules. And when it was time, because Willie, man, he caked up. That was one thing.
Yeah.
During that whole affiliates thing and the run and the tours and the different deals he had with Drama and Atlantic and Asylum, that man saved his money, invested, saved his money. So by the time when I came up, because I was a young dog when I first was going down there, and they helped me get the apartment and all that, that boy saved his money and he made his money grow. He was getting big checks from the label. He was like that last era that got the 9-360 deals, big advances.
Yeah.
He saved and flipped. And so when I got in a position up here and I started getting into venture capital and started getting into investment in real estate, I brought him back and I said, bro, this is what we're gonna do here. It's time for us to come together. And so he's been a vital piece of that. My partner Jamiel Robinson, founder of GRABB Local, has been a vital piece of that. And we've just been moving. AJ Hills, all my guys, you know what I'm saying? We've created a team to where we evaluate different opportunities and we invest together, we take risks together, and that's how we've been able to survive.
And build as well, right? Yeah. Especially in our area, in our neighborhood, it means a lot to the city. Yeah.
Appreciate that.
I would say too, man, going into flipping it back over to the spirits real quick.
Yeah.
What's your, out of your brand of spirits, what's your favorite one?
You know what? I think my favorite would have to be our signature, the Motu Viget group. You know what I mean? It bears our name, and it just means a lot, man, to be able to have push one product that has the city of Grand Rapids' motto. That's where we got that from. The motto is strength in unison. We got it from the seal of Grand Rapids. It's Latin. And we want to take Grand Rapids with us wherever we go. So I'm always going to be proudest of that one because that's our first son. That's our first baby. You know what I mean?
What's up? Switching over to music, man. I mean, you got one album. Is it one album that you're from? Is it recognize this? It was this? Or one album for the rest of your life? What are you listening to?
Man, I don't know, man. I'm such a big fan of music. I'm a big Frank Sinatra guy. Like, you know what I'm saying? I like classic. I'm a big James Brown guy.
Range.
I'm a big Marvin Gaye. You know what I'm saying? What's Going On is one of those albums for me. I think it's hard, man. Raekwon's Only Built for Cuban Links, to me, might be the best rap album of all time.
Okay.
You know, it's Cuban Links, Life After Death, and then it was written. And then Illmatic, and then Reasonable Doubt. Like, you know, I gotta look the infamous.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The Southern rap, I'm a big Outkast, ATLians. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Big fan of that. I love Future right now, though.
It's dope. That's the GOAT, man. I mean,
he's an icon. The last 10 years of music,
Damn
near gotta get a Future and Drake for the most part. Yeah. And they made that.
And hold up, man. Did y'all see that Kanye West interview?
Yes.
Bruh.
I felt that to the core.
Yeah. That was different. How you feel listening to that, though? Because, you know, for us, it made us feel good because you know that you're not off when you think those things. You know what I'm saying? And they try to box us and make us feel like we should stay like this.
Bro, I love how free of a thinker he is, man. Like, we could disagree with him on certain points, but what he's been able to accomplish, I mean, I never thought that it would be possible to eclipse Puff. Puff is one of my idols. You know what I mean? To be able to eclipse Puff even financially. You know, you can't beat Puff at what he does.
Right.
But the fact that, like, Ye is worth $9 billion or so.
That's
you know what
crazy.
I'm saying? You lap Puff and Jay-Z, and he's younger than him. Man, that's crazy.
That's nuts.
And it's not just the money. It's how he thinks about the world. It's how he wants to end homelessness. It's how he talked about being homeless and what that even means, what a home is. Ye interview was so influential. I'm glad Nori gave him the opportunity to articulate himself without ridicule and without, you know, trying to box him in and get him into a corner to fit some political narrative.
Right.
You don't have to agree with everybody, but you have to respect what that man has contributed to the art form and then what he's done in fashion.
Yes.
To be able to do that in more than one lane.
Yeah.
Man, absolutely.
Talking something different. Yeah.
Yeah, he's That's different. Fact. Yeah, he's different. And I'm not like, you know, Ye has great albums, I think. College Dropout, Late Registration, Graduation, Back to Back to Back.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Amazing albums. And then My Dark Twisted Fantasy, like.
Arguably one of the best hip hop albums ever.
Of all time. Yeah. Like, especially collaborative.
Yes.
And also from a producing level, too. It's probably one of the best produced albums ever.
Ye and Dr. Dre. You know, they're the best producers in hip hop.
Got it. You got like a Pharrell and Timberland right under there.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Pharrell and them right. Pharrell to me right there.
Yeah, that man different.
And he's designing hotels in Miami with Dave Gutman and owning the real estate and having the outdoor bars and pool. You see that he did?
Yes.
Bro, the culture is amazing.
Yeah.
And that's what we have to permeate. That's why I like you guys' podcast. When I listen, the conversations you're having, they're relevant to the community. And so what I want to be a part of is amplifying that. You know what I mean? I want to be a part of making sure people are hearing those conversations in those areas where they need to hear them.
We appreciate that, man.
Honestly, man, look, we appreciate you for stopping by. You know, I know it's a busy. You running around, you shaking hands and kissing babies. So I appreciate you stopping by, man, being able to rap with us.
I would rather not be anywhere in the world, but right here.
Hey,
baby,
look,
music and a bottle podcast, baby.
I appreciate it.
Y'all been killing it, and we've been talking about
this. Yeah, you already know what's up.
And I thought that this would be a great opportunity to do that.
I appreciate the invite. I appreciate the reach out, man. I told Willie we got to sit down in a quieter environment and really
break
rap.
It up.
Yeah, we're going to have a time, man.
That's overdue, man. It is overdue.
Yeah, man. Thank you,
two of the flyest guys in the whole Southern state right now. You see it in the ring.
You wearing an animal. You see this man got an animal on. Stop playing.
Literally, you know what I mean? Y'all came and shut down the GRUSA brunch so official.
Man, look, bro.
Crazy.
Look, the thing is, at the end of the day, bro, I'm a Detroit boy.
Yeah.
And I come over here, and at first I felt that way. I was lost. I'm like, man, it's not here for me.
Yeah.
But I get to meeting certain people.
Yeah.
Jelks, one of them, that was like, bro, they out here, and like, they doing it in ways that it inspires me to like, yo, we gotta keep going, we gotta boss up. And being a phone call away, being able to hit you with anything, bro, it's love. So I definitely appreciate it, bro.
Anything you ever need, fellas, it's on.
Definitely.
Onward and upward.
Bless you.
Let's go.
Much appreciated,
you know what's up,
bro.
Man. There we go. That's it.
How's that sound? Is that good?
Yes.
All right, perfect. All right,
we good.
Good.
Five, four.
Three, two. Hey, what's going on? It's the Music in a Bottle podcast, episode 80.
Yes, sir.
Blessed and highly, blessed and highly favored to be here with a friend of the show, Kelly Hines, coming fresh off of her event, the 7 in Fire Fashion Show. Correct? Yes. Shout out to you and Lauren. You guys were both running that together. In addition to that, you're at this beautiful event here in Grand Rapids. Wayne and I definitely want to get an interview with you. So we'd love to talk about the event. How's your experience been so far?
It's been amazing. It was overwhelmingly awesome. And full of gratitude. It honestly took me a week, though, to process it.
Yeah, that's what's up. That's what's up. Talk to the folks about what the fashion show represented.
The fashion show did not start as a fashion show. It started off as just an event. People that come together to celebrate, to bring together different cultures, ethnicities, races, personality types. And then all of a sudden, Lauren was like, well, you have lingerie, like, you have to have a fashion show.
Yes.
So we really focused everything around the show to be an event, and we weren't focused on getting signed models or people with experience. We're focused on people with good energy, good vibes, and that we're willing to collaborate and work together.
I like that.
Let's go. For sure. That's super cool.
How's your experience at this event been so far? Here.
It's cool. I didn't even know this existed here. And just to see different people, I mean, after COVID, just seeing different events go on and seeing who comes to what event, right?
Yes. So true.
It's been interesting. So and in the vibes and the ambiance and the music, I mean, you can't not have a good time here.
Agreed. Yeah, the music has been hitting.
Oh, yeah. Sure. Facts. And then going into music, you know, switching topics. Talk a little bit about your music taste. Like, what's your vibe? What you like? What's your music style?
I love everything. Like, in the car by myself, it's like hip hop, rap. You know? My kids love like hip hop and rap, so that's what we listen to. But I also love like meditation, chill.
Oh, yeah. So okay, yeah. I feel that. I feel like you need the balance. You need the balance.
Yeah.
All over the map.
I like that. So if you could give me a couple of, like, what's your artist that hit you up? What's your standout artist? Like, what artist, when they drop, you like, oh, I gotta go listen to that?
I mean, Drake always, but I feel like everybody says that.
The lover boy, you got to.
You got to.
Okay. I like that.
How about you guys?
Oh, we talk about this all day. But,
all day.
Yeah, Drake definitely is that top up there for us. But we got our tops, Drake, Cole, Kendrick.
Yep.
You push it back, you know, we got our JVs, our Nas's, the whole thing. So, you feel me?
Yeah. More recently, like Giveon.
Giveon has been a big one for us.
Yeah, for sure.
The R&B, like the Summer Walker album, you know, we love Summer Walker.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so.
I guess I should say Big Sean. I love Big Sean.
Hey,
I forget about that guy.
So. You got, we talk about that a lot. Sean is very, underrated for the amount of work he does.
Yeah. For sure.
You know what I'm saying? So
it just takes a minute to come out with new songs. We forget for a minute.
Yeah, that's all it was. And so with that, switching back over to the drinks. We are at a drink event. This is Music in a Bottle, so we talk about spirits. What's your favorite spirit? What's your favorite drink?
Right now, Motu for sure.
Okay.
Before I was introduced to Motu, though, there was a brand that was called... it's called Ocean Spray, so it's like an organic vodka.
Okay,
I was on that, but right now I'm sober, so I started sober November. This event is like, what am I doing here, right?
man, you still celebrating with us. It's all right.
Still celebrating, yeah. But Lobos, Motu, that's it.
That's dope, okay. So if you had to, you look into like your personality, right, who you are. What's the spirit, what's the drink that matches your personality? So like a pineapple and tequila or like something like that. What's that, what do you feel like pairs with you?
Ooh, I don't know. I don't even think of that. Maybe, I don't know. I just drink vodka water and I feel like
that's your energy.
Because like
you're going like straight natural earth vibes.
Yep. Yeah.
But I can turn up sometimes.
It's like rap and meditation music at once.
I like it, okay. And so the last question that we have, we've asked this to everybody. You gotta be honest with us, Kelly.
Okay.
You gotta tell us the truth.
Okay.
What's your wildest drink story?
Woo! It was in Grand Haven, on a boat. Just drank way too much, but like got super lost. It was when the scooters first came out.
Oh wow.
And I swear, like those scooters like always lead you back to home.
Yeah.
Like, I don't care like how drunk you are. Yep. I don't care like how much you don't know where you're going, they lead you home.
Yeah.
And that was the first time I got so lost. I ended up outside of Grand Haven on somebody's boat, and then like we got back on the scooter. The scooter was wasn't supposed to be like linked up to your phone with a payment, but it was. It's just magical. we ended up back at our little spot at our Airbnb.
That's dope, man. As long as you got home safe, that's all that matters.
It's an adventure.
That's lit. That's lit. That's the whole point.
That's what's up.
Kelly.
That's
what's up. Thank you. I appreciate you coming to sit down with us.
Appreciate you guys.
Hey, what's going on? It's Music in a Bottle Podcast, episode 80. We are blessed and highly favored to be here with Jamiel Robinson from GRABB Local, touching base with an icon in the city, most definitely, man. What's been up? How you been?
I've been good, man. It's been a great year, you know, despite all the obvious, you know, with COVID and everything else.
Yes.
But we're having a great year, you know. Getting ready to build out our headquarters, you know, my entrepreneurial ventures are going well, so everything is good.
Most definitely. Talk about the headquarters. Where are headquarters going to be located at?
It's going to be on the southeast side of Grand Rapids, Burton and Eastern. You know, we actually participated in the 49507 project, so, you know, we got the best mural in the city.
Yes,
sir. Hey, I'm the project manager on that one. I ain't gonna lie. Eastside, he did his thing, man.
Eastside went off.
He went crazy.
Yeah.
I asked him to do one in the crib. I need one.
We gotta have that.
Yeah.
Man.
That's a piece.
Man, definitely. Even on a cloudy day, man, you right by that. Look at that mural, man. It's so bright, so beautiful, so vibrant, man. It puts you in a good mood.
Yeah.
That's awesome. The vision for GRABB Local, what do you see in the next year or so?
Man,
5 years, whatever, man.
So, you know, we're going to continue to build out, you know, our space, build out the district. You know, so we call the building the district or District 2012, and it's all about, you know, bringing a collective of black businesses to that area, bringing more economic development, creating more wealth, you know, for people who reside in that area that look like me and look like you. So that's what we're really doing. So the next 5 years is just continue to build upon what we've been doing for almost 10 years now.
That's what's up, man. How's your experience been at the event here?
The experience has been great, man. You know, I always appreciate, you know, a good party, but it's more than that. It's us being able to bring the east side and the west side of Michigan together, you know, and do business and do commerce with each other, but also expose, you know, our community to all the different black-owned spirits, man. It's great, you know, it's great vibes.
I love it, man. I know a big thing about this event for sure is the representation, right? Everything black here.
All black everything.
Talk about the importance of, you know, really hitting on that, you know, while we're in West Michigan and that contradiction, but while we're trying to fix that.
Well, you know, Grand Rapids was named the second worst city economically for black people back in 2015. And so for us, you know, we took that personal. And so ever since then, and even before then, we began building to have a culmination of an event like this, to where we're bringing more awareness and bringing more patronage and more dollars to black-owned businesses. And so people who leave this event will know about these different brands. So when they're going to whatever their favorite local restaurant or whatever their favorite local retailer, and they see these different brands in there, or begin to request the brands. Because a lot of times people don't understand that if you go to any retailer, you can request that they carry a certain brand and they will eventually pick that up. So the power is with the people. And so if you're going in and we're going in after we learn about all these different brands and start saying, hey, you know, retailer X or retailer Y, we want you to carry these brands, it definitely helps to promote and bring these businesses more awareness and more dollars and more circulation.
I like that. You touched on your entrepreneurship, you know what I'm saying, and being a very fluent and rapid entrepreneur. I know you to be in a lot of different bags. Talk about the, you know, your story or your lane and your zone in that. You know, how'd you get, you know, acquainted with Jelks and, you know, Willie, and how you pushed that and how you started to, you know, how you branched up?
Yeah, me and Jelks, we go back to high school, you know, so I was a senior, Jelks was a junior. We had to take this elective class together, so that's how we met. And then from then, it's just been, you know, us building our relationship. You know, Jelks and Willie has been good, and so it's just really, you know, just through mutual friends and connections that, you know, we built the team that we have. And so, you know, when it started from us doing more community advocacy and things like that. But my story is I come from a family of entrepreneurs, a family of business owners. It's all always we're going to eventually get into business. And so, you know, we just, you know, just looking to get to the next level together. And so it's easy to achieve more when you have a team. You know, everybody brings their strength, everybody brings their uniqueness, and it just makes each and everything that we do just more impactful and more meaningful.
I like that. Talk to me a little bit about, you know, your first baby, Motu, and then, you know, how y'all branched out and, you know, the brand itself, the spirits.
Yeah, so, you know, we launched our brand, our wine and spirits company back in 2019. We started off with our champagne. We can actually call it a champagne because we're grandfathered in. So we actually have a champagne product. And so from there, we knew we didn't just want to be ambassadors. We didn't want to be brand ambassadors. We actually wanted to form a company, and so that's what we set out to do. And so we knew we were going to slowly roll out multiple products. And so currently we have our Motu Viget Brut. We have our Ebony Supreme Vodka. We just dropped our Eye Candy, She Saw, She Conquered. And we have several more that we're going to roll out, especially with us opening up our own wine bar on Lake Michigan and Muskegon. So we're going to roll out a lot of different unique brands that only you will be able to exclusively get at our wine bar. So we're going to continue to build out our product portfolio as well as do some exclusive things on the lakeshore.
Another thing I think about, especially when we talk about, like, you know, your team and just in general, I know you to be somebody that you work hard and you do the entrepreneurship thing, but you kind of stay more behind the scenes, right? Talk a little bit about how you build a team and how, you know, a team has different players, you know, and everybody doesn't have to be that front face. You know, there's a lot of work behind the scenes that's just as important.
Yeah, the thing that I always say is a lot of people from our community and other communities, you know, they'd rather be more famous than they make money. You know, everybody has a responsibility on the team. You know, so I carry a different hat, you know, but the thing is, you know, it's only one quarterback on the field at a time. It's only a few receivers. It's only a few linemen. It's the centers. And so everybody plays that important role. And each of us, you know, may play quarterback at different points within us actually running and constructing our businesses. So when it's time for me to take the ball and run it, I'm going to do that. You know, other times, you know, I'll be, you know, blocking for the other teammates. And so the goal is for us to continue to score. And that's what we're looking to do. So a lot of times you have people who everybody wants the ball at the same time, and it just doesn't work that way. And so I think each of us being secure in who we are and all of us being respectively, you know, built to do the things that we've done respectively and separately, it makes for when we come together, it's more like, you know, the 80s TV show Voltron. You know, so we all come together and we slay shit.
I love that. I rock with it. For sure.
With that, switching over to music.
Yep, gotta hear music.
Get about a podcast covering wine, you know, covering music. What you've been listening to lately? Or talk to me about your origins. That's one thing when we were talking to a lot of people about. Where does your music, what's your music foundation, Jamiel?
Man, you know, I listen to a lot of stuff. You know, my dad used to play instruments. He used to play the electric guitar. He used to play the drums. You know, so I have an appreciation for, like, rock and roll. I have appreciation just growing up, you know, in a black household, you know, with that clean-up music on Saturdays. It'd be that Motown or that 70s.
Yes,
you know, so, you know, I have a mix of all of that. So, you know, I really look at music as more of either what mood am I in or what mood am I trying to be in, you know, from that standpoint. So it really is mood music for me. So, you know, I'll listen to the new stuff like Gunna. Like, I really like Gunna. I like Lil Baby. I like the baby, you know, but then I'll also listen to some Diana Ross. I'll listen to some Aerosmith.
Yeah.
You know, it just really depends on, you know, like how I'm feeling, you know, whatever, you know, and if I need to focus and lock in or however I want to feel. So it's really a broad range. And so I've got appreciation for, like, instruments and stuff just from my pops. Definitely listen to Prince. You know, my pops love Prince. I love Prince. You know, like MJ, like, you know, the GOATs.
Yeah,
most definitely. And everybody can resonate with that Sunday cleanup music.
You got to. Yeah, if you ain't clean up on Saturdays, I don't even know. Yeah. I don't know if I can trust you. I ain't gonna lie. Mom's definitely woke me up bright and early for the cleanup.
Man.
Yeah, yes. Respect.
Of course, man, of course. Man, with that being said, man, much appreciated for you to come up.
I know.
Wait, any more questions?
No, definitely. I wanted to talk more about, like, what inspired you to go for that champagne first? Like, I know your first choice is that champagne. Why that spirit of all?
You know, the honest decision behind that is because we're getting ready to open up Ambiance GR. And so, you know, we're going to have the Premier Lounge in downtown Grand Rapids. You know, we're going to have everyone else bubbles. Why not have our own bubbles? You know, so it was more so about us, you know, vertically integrating within that business. And so us having not only a lounge, but then also having our champagne that we'll sell and celebrate in the lounge, but then even reaching broader to the retail. And so that was it. The Ebony Vodka, you know, you have to have a vodka. That's just kind of like standard. Like, that's just a product that if you have multiple products out, you got to have a vodka. That's the most universal when it comes to being out in bars and restaurants.
Okay. I like that. And the last thing I asked Jelks, but I definitely want to get it from your standpoint too. Talking to, like, young entrepreneurs, people just get into it, following their passion, their dreams, what's some advice you can give to those young guys?
Man, you got to do the work. don't run from the work, don't hide from the work. You have to do the work. A lot of times, you know, people always see, and Hov said this, Nipsey said this, a lot of people said this. You know, everybody want to emulate what success looks like. Nobody wanted to come in here and copy the hard work it took to get there. You know, like Nipsey called it the marathon for a reason, because it took Nipsey about 10 years to get to his victory lap. You know, from that standpoint. And so nothing is built overnight. You know, nothing comes easy. So people make it look easy, but the shit's hard. Entrepreneurship is hard. You know, if it was easy, everyone would do it. So definitely put in the work. You know, I always say, if you honor the work will honor you.
I love that.
Man, I can't even say nothing else after that. That's it right there, man.
Much appreciated. Jamiel Robinson with GRABB Local, man. Also, just supporting the brands here, man. Y'all really killed it with this event.
Oh, man, appreciate it, man. Thanks for having me on, guys.
Always.
What's going on, Michigan in the Bottle Podcast, episode 80. You know what I'm saying? We rolling, we rocking. We here at the Motu Black Spirits event. You know what I'm saying? And we still chopping it with some business owners. A couple guests at the event. So we got Keisha here next to me. Go ahead, Keisha. Give me your rundown. Let them know who you is, where you from. You know what I'm saying? And any dope things you got going on. Let them know.
All right. So my name is Keisha Jones. I'm from Bend Harbor, Michigan. I'm a branding expert, so I help people start their business, grow their business, and I also help with promotions, interviews over Instagram, and just, you know, just putting yourself out there. I'm here in the Grand Rapids area, and I graduated from Grand Valley, where I know Wayne.
Let's go.
Lakers for life. But yeah, that's a little bit about me.
That's what's up.
So you're out of Benton Harbor, but you reside in Grand Rapids now.
Yep.
I love that. How's your experience been at the event tonight?
It's been great. Just networking, tasting different wines and different liquors, different everything. It's lit.
Most definitely. I like it. What's been your favorite spirit so far?
You said my favorite spirit?
Yeah.
I gotta go with the Motu, but I like the Lobo, the Anejo one.
Okay. Yeah. Gotta get that Anejo in.
Yeah, Anejo is my favorite.
I feel you. That was my next question. Your favorite drink, period. What's your favorite type of Anejo?
Anejo, anything.
Yeah, okay.
I love it.
Anything. So we're going up your personality. Talk about your personality and like what's a drink that matches your personality?
I say champagne.
Okay, you said you're the bubbly?
Because every bubbly? Day is a celebration, okay. You know?
Okay.
I love it.
I like that. I gotta
celebrate all the wins, all the goals, and I've been pushing towards everything, so.
Okay, I like that a lot. Switching back over, talk a little bit about, you know, the representation here. You see it's all black everything. How you feeling about that, being in the space where it's all black, everything's a vibe here? Talk about how that's important, especially in West Michigan.
I just think that it's definitely important just networking within the community. Black owned, this is great. Like just seeing this in the city of Grand Rapids, this is like basically my first time just experiencing this type of event. Yeah. So it's lit, and I definitely look forward to networking and seeing you guys in the future as well. So
that's dope. Okay, I got one more question for you. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely a little, we've been getting some crazy answers, but you gotta let us know, you gotta tell us the truth. You can't lie.
I don't lie.
All right, bet.
My name the Real Keish.
Okay, all right, bet. Real Keish.
And me,
let's get it, let's get it. All right, so you gotta give us your craziest drinking story right now.
Dang. Crazy. I say it happened at Grand Valley, actually.
Of course.
It happened at Grand Valley. It was homecoming.
Okay, which one? What year?
19.
Oh yeah, it was raining and shit. Yeah, it was wild day. Go ahead, talk about it.
No, I was drinking from like I'll say 9 a.m. I woke up drinking.
Oh
yeah,
oh you going crazy?
Yeah, fell asleep in the car.
Okay.
At home, coming, didn't know where I was at. Then I went to this party. It was like a party afterwards.
Okay.
And I don't know. It was just crazy. That was literally my crazy. I don't have no really.
No, that's the dog, but that's cool. You know what I'm saying? What's the details though? Like you said, you woke up in a car. How'd you end up that morning? Did you end up at home? Were you in your bed?
It's crazy because I had an edible too. That's why I didn't know where I was at.
See?
And well, I don't mess with edibles.
Yeah. I'm gonna see you.
Yeah, right.
So homecoming was lit that year, so I can't really remember, but that was my litest moment.
Right. I feel it. I love to hear it. Keisha, thank you. Especially being a GV alum, it's good to see you out here. See you still in West Michigan, man. Obviously, you from around here, but it's good to catch up and kick it. Thank you, man. Thank you for being here.
All right. Thanks for having me, y'all.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Hey, speaking about a podcast episode 80, we here.
80.
Man, 80. What a show.
We did 80 crazy. Yeah, this nuts. This different.
I'm emotionally drained. I mean, mentally drained.
I'm tired.
The boy Kobe gonna meet us next week. 81.
About the game, 81 with the
My
Kobe
boy
game.
Kobe gonna see us next week.
I like it. I like it. Juan came with bars. Hey, shout out to you working the camera, man, behind the scenes.
Yeah, you killed it.
Yes,
man,
sir.
Thank you. Shout out to Marks, man. My guy dipping by there. You know y'all know he's been pretty fast.
Shout out to Ranger for having a plug for everybody in the city.
Hold on,
and
man.
He's not even from here.
How y'all let me run it down here? I ain't even from around here, man.
Yeah, I don't even know y'all.
Hey, good bars. Good bars.
No, man. Hey, man. It's a blessing, man.
Hey, let me run it down here. I ain't even from around here. Yo. 6666. Oh, my God.
No, man. Again, shout out, bro. Bro, D, you already know what's up, man.
Man, I ain't do nothing. I'm just here,
look,
man.
Bro.
Hey, how y'all doing?
It's a team effort, man. We all play ball, man.
Humble service, man. Humble service.
Shout out to Mark, too.
Man, big shout out to
Mark. Yes, big shout out to Mark. Shots fired at Mark, boy. The shooter.
That boy got his photos and said,
I'm out of here. Again, thank you to Motu.
Yes,
Jelks, Jonathan, Willie. You guys, thank y'all for blessing our platform. Thank you guys for having us at this special event.
Yes.
You know, thank you to all of the makers that we had, you know, come talk to us. That was definitely dope. Shout out to all you guys. And it was just a great event put on by, you know, those guys over at Motu. So thank you all again for having us.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I hope y'all enjoyed the pod. You know what I'm saying? Y'all heard from a few different people. They dropped a few gems as far as business goes.
Yep.
And let you know about the spirits they had coming up in their moves for West Michigan. You know, and shout out to the guests we had as well, giving us a little insight on their lives. And, at the end of the day, man, it's Music in a Bottle podcast, and all it is people vibing over spirits and a good time in music. You know what I'm saying? So
great, man. That's what we're here for. And it's been a blessing to be at this event. See so many people that look like us in the space, and that is, it's not, it's very hard to see people like us in West Michigan, let alone, I mean, Michigan as a whole, to be honest.
Back.
Yeah.
Back.
It's great to see us getting busy here. It's been a blast, and it's been a celebration. DJ killed it here.
Murdered it.
Killed it.
The sick thing was, we was doing a couple of interviews, and I damn near was ready to stop it just to listen to the song.
I know, man. I know he threw on a lot. Like, man, he threw on Busta Rhymes on a lot. I was like,
dude.
Man, it's put Race My Mind on, and I damn near tripped out. Yeah. I don't even know if Race My Mind came up. I'm like, I got the keys.
I know.
Race My Mind came on in here?
Yes.
I didn't even hear it,
but,
dude.
For a good 30 seconds.
Oh, awesome. My God. But, not 30. You can't play 30 seconds of Drake. You got to play the whole shit.
Did he play Drake? I ain't hear Drake.
A little bit.
He played Race My Mind.
I ain't hear Drake. I ain't hear no J. Cole or Kendrick.
I ain't hear Kendrick. But
he did a great
I heard
job.
J. Cole for sure.
He did great for sure.
The DJ did his thing, man.
Yeah, shout out to everybody that was a part, man. This was dope. And it's episode 80, man. I know we are, you know, the milestone numbers. It's not really, a milestone number. But even us, man, our hands on the back, man. This is 80.
Yeah.
80 episodes, man.
Greatest wide receiver ever. Jerry Rice, where are we?
Come on, man.
Woo. Let's go.
Come on, man. End of the day, man. We're going to keep serving y'all. We're going to keep giving y'all this insight.
Yep.
Talk culture. Talk spirits. Talk music. You know what I'm saying? And keep developing and forming from here, man. But y'all got anything else, man? Look.
That's it, man. This is episode 80 of the Music in a Bottle podcast, and we out of here.
313 to the 616.
Thanks.